since. One month, and diversity to till we are used to the ethnicity and nation states. So, welcome.
I cannot hear you. I cannot hear you.
অন্তর্জাম স্যার, আপনার ভয়েস ক্লিয়ার আসুনি, শুনুনি স্যার।
So can anyone hear me?
Yes sir, yes sir. স্যার আপনার ভয়েস আসছে কিন্তু অন্তর্জাম স্যারঙ্কর ভয়েস আসুনি। Yes sir, আপনার ভয়েস অডিবল হচ্ছে স্যার।
আচ্ছা,
আজ্ঞা।
ওকে দেন, ওকে দেন। So should I start?
গোটে মিনিট বলতে। হ্যালো
Yes.
হ্যালো স্যার, স্টার্ট করুন। অন্তর্জামী স্যারঙ্কর টিকে নেট প্রবলেম হচ্ছে,
Yes, sir, yes, sir. I'm back. Hello, sir. Sorry, sir. Extremely sorry. There is some
okay.
internet problem. So now I am in the session only. So let's start, sir. Let's start the session. We'll discuss in later on. Continue, please.
Okay. So thank you, Antarjami. This is my fourth talk or lecture. On ethnicity and nation state. If you see the chronology, in the first talk I gave on pluralism and diversity, second talk I gave on identity politics, third talk on social movement, and fourth talk on ethnicity. And if you see all these themes, you can find an interconnection. And what is that interconnection? That interconnection is how to democratize the democracy. Democracy is not merely an institution. Democracy is all about settling disputes. Democracy is all about reconciling conflicts. Conflicts are very much natural to individual or citizens, right? So in the pluralism also, I talked about how to maintain the diversity. The main role of democracy is to maintain and sustain the diversity. If there is no maintenance or sustenance of diversity, then we cannot be proud of our democracy. And in the identity politics also, I said that how that identity politics is happening today. And if you remember, then you will find that marginalized category, I'm talking about today's identity politics, how marginalized category they are, feeling of alienation is actually the reason of the creation of identity politics. And in the social movement also, I said how to do a social movement, how the marginalized section, how the powerless and helpless section of our society, they will have a movement, what Gandhi calls passive resistance, or Gramsci called anti-passive revolution or active revolution against the passive revolution, which is of course giving benefits to the elite. So today we will deal with ethnicity. In the ethnicity also, we need to understand what is ethnicity, right? So ethnicity, it is a mobilization of a group who share common attributes in terms of culture, language, religion, history, etc., and who are different from one another, right? I'm actually going to identity politics. ए आइडेंटिटी पॉलिटिक्स टा कोंठु आसुचु किए करुचु आइडेंटिटी पॉलिटिक्स ए आइडेंटिटी पॉलिटिक्स सर्टेनली गोटे पर्टिकुलर आइडेंटिटी रु ही आसुचु से पर्टिकुलर आइडेंटिटी टा कोन ना ताको आमे कहुचे गोटे एथनिक कम्युनिटी बा एथनिक ग्रुप नाउ हाउ टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट एथनिक ग्रुप और व्हाट आर द इंपोर्टेंट फीचर्स ऑफ एथनिक ग्रुप और एथनिसिटी देयर आर मेनली थ्री फीचर्स ऑफ एथनिसिटी. One is the objective feature, second is the subjective feature, third is the behavioral feature. What is the objective feature of ethnicity? Objective feature of ethnicity constitute what we get at our cognitive orientation. And jo jinsa ta ame dekhi paruchu, jo jinsa ta ame jani paruchu, to sei ta ku ame kahuche objective. Objective means something which is observable, something what you can see. A objective feature kon, what is that objective feature of the ethnicity? Na ame dekhuche on the basis of language gote category srushti hochanti, on the basis of territory gote category srushti hochanti, on the category of religion gote category srushti hochanti, on the basis of culture gote category srushti hochanti. Tano hue to language ko nei ki gote category hei pare बा लांगुएज आउ कल्चर को नहीं भी गोटे कैटेगोरी हो पारे. गोटे एग्जाम्पल तुमको दौर लांगुएज आधार में आम कौन एथनिक ग्रुप अच्छी ना आम आम जो लिंगुइस्टिक डिविजन ऑफ आवर स्टेट है तो से आम देखीचु कौन कि ओडिया एज ए एथनिक ग्रुप, बेंगली एज ए एथनिक ग्रुप, तेलेंगाना एज ए एथनिक ग्रुप. टे जदि मन पक यू कैन रिमेम्बर कि हाउ ओडिया पीपल दे डोंट बदर अबाउट नॉन ओडिया पीपल इन हैदराबाद यूनिवर्सिटी, हाउ तेलंगाना एससी दे आर नॉट सीरियस अबाउट दि ओडिया एससी. सो दिस इज ए एथनिक ग्रुप ऑन दि बेसिस ऑफ लैंग्वेज. एंड व्हाट इज दि एथनिक ग्रुप ऑन दि बेसिस ऑफ टेरिटोरी? ऑन दि बेसिस ऑफ टेरिटोरी यू कैन गो टू आवर आवर साउथ इंडिया, राइट? In South India, they always ask for what is the term called? They always ask for Dravid Nadu, What is Dravidi Nadu? Because for them, their territory is different from the North India, and they don't think that they are part of the North India. So this Dravidi Nadu is not only based on territory, it is also based on language. And what is the language? What is the main language of South India on which, the Dravidi Nadu, the concept of Dravidi Nadu is based? That language is the Tamil. And Tamil has a serious problem with the Hindi. And what is the serious problem? Now, which is the oldest language? The oldest language of India, Tamil people, they say that Tamil is the oldest language, and Tamil should be the, a national language. But there is they claim that there is an imposition of Hindi on them. So this is territory. And on the basis of religion, you can find, this BJP AIM, Asauddin Oasis Party, think about, on the basis of caste also, you can think about Samajwadi Party, Bahujan Samajwadi Party. That is on the basis of caste. This is also another kind of, ethnic group or ethnic community. Then on the basis of culture. So the objective features of ethnicity is something which is observable, something jonta ku tame dekhi paribo jani parcho, au tara adhar sabu kon heitae na tara adhar language hei pare, tara adhar territory hei pare, tara adhar religion hei pare, tara adhar caste hei pare, tara adhar culture bhi hei pare. So this is the objective feature of ethnicity. The next is the subjective feature. So what is subjective feature? Now the subjective feature is a sense of belongingness. From where belong. You may be staying in America, but you are not belonging to America. You are belonging to India. Yudaga ame kouche prabasi bharatiya. Prabasi bharatiya. Jemiti ame aji kouche prabasi odia. Corona samoy re jemiti gote to danger achi ki saman asile amara sankhya badhiba ebe baduchi corona ko sankhya. But the concept of prabasi odia kahi ki samane asile na eita hoche tankaro rajya ame kemti tanku tankuri rajya ru gute corona rogo pai bitadito kordabu tenu their belongingness is not in Surat, their belongingness is in Odisha, right? That is sense of belongingness. That why do people think that they belong to a definite culture, right? They belong to a definite culture. I may be staying in Surat, but I am belonging to Odisha. I may be staying in America, but I am belonging to India. So this sense of belongingness is nothing but our attachment, our emotional attachment, our perception. So this is this constitute the subjective feature of ethnicity. Then the behavioral feature. What is the behavioral feature? Now the behavioral feature, it is because of the interaction of one ethnic group with other, right? So when you are interacting with another community or other, then you think this is self and that is other. This is self, that is other. For example, good example daba jemti ki ame kandhamal le ame dekhilo kandha o pananga bhitare gote prakar ro riot hei gala conflict hei gala to sethi mostly kandha mane nijuku RSS ba hindutva sahito connect kale au pano mane mostly Christian manko sahito nijuku connect kareithile. तो जतेबेले दंगा हला सेतेबेले देखा गला कोन ना कंधो माने पाणो मानकु अटैक करिचंती माने पाणो माने भी किछि क्रिश्चियन हेचंती मैक्सिमम पाणो कंधो मारले से माने क्रिश्चियनिटी रे कन्वर्ट हेचंती बट फ्यू नंबर ऑफ कंधो से माने भी क्रिश्चियनिटी रे भी कन्वर्ट हेचंती किंतु जतेबेले अटैक हला सेतेबेले काहे कि पाणो मानक ऊपर अटैक हेगा जदी सेटा कम्युनल रायट थिला तबे तो सबु कन्वर्टेड मान को ऊपर अटैक होबार थिला सबु जो माने भी कन्वर्ट हेचंदी पाण भी कन्वर्ट हेची कंध भी कन्वर्ट हेची तो जदि अटैक होबार थिला जो माने कन्वर्ट हेचंदी बोथ पाण कंध समान को ऊपर अटैक होबार थिला किंतु देखा गला कोन ना कंध ख्रिस्ट कन्वर्टेड ख्रिस्टियन मान को ऊपर एते अटैक हेई नाही अटैक हेची पाण ख्रिस्टियन मान को ऊपर अटैक हेची ता माने सेठी आमे कोन बुझुचू ना जतबेले जने अटैक करबा पई जाउची सतबेले से देखुची अच्छा सी मो कैटेगरी को बिलोंग करुची ना मोर अपोजिट कैटेगरी को बिलोंग करुची बहुत गुड़ा हिंदू पाण को ऊपर भी अटैक हो जाए तो से मु रिसर्च करी तो से मत कहे कि सर जी आम तो कन्वर्टेड है कि आम उप कहीं अटैक हो गला तेणु आम भावु एटा ख्रीटियान आ हिंदू मान भितर गोटे कम्युनाल राइट नुह एटा हूँ गोटे एथनिक कनफ्लिक्ट एटी कंध मान आम उप राग थी से सीए आमको धर्म धर्मांतरीकरण व कनवर्जन ना आम उप गोटे अटैक करदे गले तो जितेबाला कंध मैंने जाऊँच पाण मान अटाक करने से आम गोटे देखुचे द कनसेप्ट अफ द सेन्स अफ सेल्फ एंड सेन्स अफ अदर जदि ये मोर कम्युनिटी बिलंग कर कंध जदि देखुची ये मो कम्युनिटी बिलंग कर तबे जदि भी से नो कन्वर्जन हो किसी करी आदि जन मो कम्युनिटी बिलंग न करुची तेब मुझे अटाक करी दैट इज नथिंग बट द इंटराक्शन अफ वन एथनिक ग्रुप over another so that is that constitute the behavioral feature of ethnicity right so this is the understanding of ethnicity so what is the understanding of nation state we know that what is state in political science I will not go into that but what is nation nation means what a nation is a belongingness to a particular geography what is applicable for ethnicity that is also applicable for nationality when all the ethnic community ethnic group they have their own concept of nationhood they think that they are nation so nation is not state so what is a nation state means there is sovereignty sovereignty means externally and internally free there is geographical entity they must have a geography territory and this is very important the last point that is shared sentiment based on history culture language and civilization all these three constitute a nation state now from this sense some scholar think that that India is not a nation state why now because India has a large number of nationalities within it hence it is not a nation state however in India the nation state or the multinational state are used interchangeably tano in a strict sense India is not a nation state kahinki ना इंडिया भितर मल्टीपुल नेशनालिटीज अच्छे मल्टीपुल नेशनालिज्म अच्छे तेणु इंडिया को किसी स्कॉलर कहती जे इंडिया हूँ गोटे मल्टीनेशनल स्टेट इट इज नॉट ए नेशन स्टेट बट मल्टीनेशनल स्टेट आउ नेशन स्टेट इंडियन कंटेक्सट गोटे इंटरचेंजेबली भी व्यवहार करा जाए कहीं इंडिया in the world right in the arena of world india must have its unique identity so to maintain a unique identity before the world we cannot discard or forget the concept of nation state so we can say that our mode of nation state our mode of nation state is multinational state it is not like pakistan it is a multinational state. that is a islamic state we are having multinational state jota ko ame kahuche secular state right and let us understand the context of ethnicity so if you go back to the post independence period then you will find that our statesmen they were busy in the project of nation building, right? So I didn't use the word politician. I used the word statesman. It's because there is a subtle difference between the statesman and the politician. You know, the subtle difference is that the politician always thinks about the next election, and a statesman always thinks about the next generation. So all these stalwarts in the post-independent period, they were not politicians. They were the statesmen, and they were busy in the project of nation building. So the main purpose of nation building was how to maintain democracy and development. Amku duita dako jinsa darkar. If you remember the first class, I told you there is a dialectical relation between the development and democracy. Development democracy should not be understood in a binary perspective. If you understand in a dialectical perspective, then you can understand that democracy and development both need each other to grow, right? And that dialectical understanding was present in the mind of our statesmen. So the main purpose of our statesmen was the nation building. And how to build a nation? Now, it is only through establishing a dialectical connection between the development and democracy. And they were very much conscious about that, that in India, India is not a nation, rather than India is many nations. There are multiple nationalities, multiple ethnic groups within India. So the top priority of our statesmen was the goal of nation building. And tanko bhitre hope thila se asa ta kona na se bhabutile jodi democracy or development jodi ame taku perfectly maintain kariba tebe dine dine amo bhitre jo gote ethnic diversity achi amo bhitre jo gote ethnicity ko nei ki gote prakar ro inferiority complex achi seita dhire dhire duro hei jibo au nation building jo nation building project achi seita dhire dhire kon karibo na se jo ethnic diversity amo bhitre jo antagonistic attitude of different ethnic communities achi seita ko nation building taro bhitru ko samahita karinabo माने सेटा को से एब्जॉर्ब करिनबो एंड आवर नेशन विल मूव फॉरवर्ड्स राइट आवर नेशन कैन बी द बेस्ट डेमोक्रेटिक नेशन एंड आवर नेशन कैन बी ए डेवलप्ड नेशन डेवलप्ड लाइक अमेरिका राइट सो इन द फर्स्ट टू डिकेड्स ऑफ द पोस्ट इंडिपेंडेंस पीरियड द क्वेस्ट फॉर नेशन बिल्डिंग वाज बेस्ड ऑन मॉडर्नाइजेशन और डेवलपमेंटल westernization model. Hello, am I audible?
Yes sir, continue.
Am I audible?
Yes sir, you are very much.
Okay,
audible.
Thank you. Please so continue. In the past two decades,
yes sir.
In the past two decades of post independence period, the quest for nation building was based on the modernization or developmental westernization model. Taku ame kahi pariya kon na the Nehruvian model. तेणु से नेहरू भियान मॉडलटा प्रथम टू डिकेड्स माने 47 बा 50 रे हमर स्वाधीनता हला 50 रु 60 60 रु 70 तो 50 रु 70 भितरे नेहरू भियान मॉडलटा काम कला बट 80s रे माने 80s माने 70 रु 80 टा होचु 80s 70 रु 80 भितरे हिंदू राइट विंग माने हिंदू राइट फोर्स सेमाने डेवलप कले इंडियन पॉलिटिक्स रे आगुरे गुडा सब किछि नथिला ए सब जिंस कांग्रेस रे थिला कांग्रेस ही बीजेपी जनसंघ प्रथमे जनसंघ एटा सेठु डेवलप कला आ सेमाने कोन देखिला ना दे अटेम्प्ट टू प्रोजेक्ट इंडिया एज ए नेशन स्टेट तनो आगुरु ए कांसेप्ट ऑफ नेशन स्टेट नथिला आगुरु केवल किछि हमर एथनिक ग्रुप थिले एथनिक कम्युनिटी थिले सेमाने तांकर यूनिक फॉर्म ऑफ तांको भितरे गोटे प्रकार रो नेशनलिटी थिला आउ सेही नेशनलिटी काले नेशन स्टेट रे किछि बाधा सृष्टि करिवो सेथि पई नेहरू भियान मॉडल को अप्लाई करा जाय थिला भाबुतले कि माने एई एंटागोनिज्म डेवलप करिवनी समस्त सुख और शांति रे जीवन को अतिवाहित करिवे କିନ୍ତୁ ଯେତେବେଳେ ବିଜେପି ଆସିଲା ସେତେବେଳେ ବିଜେପି କ'ଣ କଲା ନା ଇଣ୍ଡିଆକୁ ଗୋଟେ ପ୍ରକାରର ୟୁନୋ କଲଚରାଲ ନ୍ୟାସନାଲିଜିମ୍ ଦେଲା ରାଇଟ୍ ଇଟ୍ ଗେଭ୍ ଏ ସେନ୍ସ ଅଫ୍ କଲଚରାଲ ନ୍ୟାସନାଲିଜିମ୍ ଟୁ ଇଣ୍ଡିଆନ୍ ନେସନ୍ ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ ସେ କଲଚରାଲ ନ୍ୟାସନାଲିଜିମ୍ କ'ଣ ନା ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ସମଥିଙ୍ଗ ୟୁନୋ ହିନ୍ଦୁସ୍ତାନ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ସମଥିଙ୍ଗ ୟୁନୋ ହିନ୍ଦୁ ନ୍ୟାସନାଲିଜିମ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ୍ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଡିଫାଇନ୍ ହିନ୍ଦୁ ନ୍ୟାସନାଲିଜିମ୍ ଏଜ୍ ଏ ଭେରି ଇନ୍କ୍ଲୁସିଭ୍ କନ୍ସେପ୍ଟ ଏଜ୍ ଏ ଭେରି ଇନ୍କ୍ଲୁସିଭ୍ କନ୍ସେପ୍ଟ ବଟ୍ ଦେର୍ ଆର୍ ସର୍ଟନ୍ ଏକ୍ସଟ୍ରିମ୍ ପଲିଟିସିଆନ୍ ଦେ ଗିଭ୍ ଏ ଭେରି ଏକ୍ସକ୍ଲୁସିଭ୍ ଅଣ୍ଡରଷ୍ଟାଣ୍ଡିଂ ଅଫ୍ ହିନ୍ଦୁ ହିନ୍ଦୁଇଜିମ୍ You know, as I said in the earlier class, if you remember, Hindu or Hindutva theoretically stands for, that is actually the secularism. That is actually secularism. But that Hindu or Hindutva, that two words, since it is derived from one organized religion called Hinduism, then other religious people, they are having a kind of psychological problem and they prefer secularism instead of Hinduism. That's a separate thing. So this gap, the emergence of BJP on the national platform, this gave a challenge to the nation state in two ways. Kaun se huye kaun? Now it does not recognize the existence of other faith which disagree with it, and it legitimizes social hierarchy based on barna system. Tenu ame jo kohuche gote cultural nationalism ba hindu nationalism ra gote positive side ta ko mu kahili hindu nationalism ra gote negative side achi se negative side kon na it legitimizes it justifies the hindu barna system. Hindu barna system is based on ascriptive value, right? No, sorry, caste is based on ascriptive value, but in barna system you start with ascriptive value, but subsequently there is a chance of mobility and you can go to the achievement value, and accordingly, you know, a Dalit can be a Brahmin can be a Dalit according to the barna system. So barna system, caste system, there is a difference. Again, ଆମେ ଆଉ ଏ ଡାଇଭର୍ଜନ ନେଇକି ତା ଭିତରକୁ ଆଉ ଯିବା ନାହିଁ ବଟ୍ ଏଇ ଯେଉଁ ହିନ୍ଦୁ ନ୍ୟାସନାଲିଜିମ୍ ବିଜେପି ଆସିସାରିଲା ପରେ କ'ଣ ହେଲା ନା ଇଏ ବର୍ଣ୍ଣ ସିଷ୍ଟମକୁ ଜଷ୍ଟିଫାଏ କଲା ଆଉ ଗୋଟେ କ'ଣ କଲା ନା ସେ କହିଲା ଯଦି ତୁମେ ମୋ ସହିତ ଏଗ୍ରି କରୁନ ଇଫ୍ ୟୁ ଥିଙ୍କ୍ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ୟୁଆର ଏନ୍ସେଷ୍ଟର୍ସ ଆର୍ ନଟ୍ ବିଲଙ୍ଗିଂ ଟୁ ଦି ହିନ୍ଦୁଇଜିମ୍ ଦେନ୍ ୟୁ ଆର୍ ନଟ୍ ଏ ନ୍ୟାସନାଲିଷ୍ଟ ୟୁ ଆର୍ ନଟ୍ ଏ ପ୍ୟାଟ୍ରିଅଟ୍ ତେଣୁ ମୁସଲମାନ ମାନେ ଯଦି ଯେଉଁଟା ଇଫ୍ ୟୁ ରିମେମ୍ବର ସୁବ୍ରମଣ୍ୟମ ସ୍ୱାମୀ ଏଠି କ୍ୱାଇଟ୍ ଫିଟ୍ ହେଉଛି ଇଫ୍ ୟୁ ରିମେମ୍ବର ସୁବ୍ରମଣ୍ୟମ ସ୍ୱାମୀ ସେ ସଦାବେଳେ କ'ଣ କହନ୍ତି ନା ସେ ସଦାବେଳେ କହନ୍ତି ଇଫ୍ ୟୁ ୱାଣ୍ଟ ଟୁ ଷ୍ଟେ ଇନ୍ ଇଣ୍ଡିଆ ଦେନ୍ ୟୁ ହାଭ୍ ଟୁ ଆକ୍ସେପ୍ଟ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ୟୁଅର୍ ଏନ୍ସେଷ୍ଟର୍ସ ଆର୍ ଅର୍ ୱେର୍ ହିନ୍ଦୁ ସେମାନେ ହିନ୍ଦୁ ଥିଲେ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଇଫ୍ ୟୁ ଡୋଣ୍ଟ ଏଗ୍ରି ୱିଥ୍ ଦିସ୍ ଦେନ୍ ୟୁ ଆର୍ ନଟ୍ ଇଣ୍ଡିଆନ୍ ରାଇଟ୍ ସୋ ଦିସ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦି ଫାର୍ଷ୍ଟ ଚ୍ୟାଲେଞ୍ଜ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଦି ସେକେଣ୍ଡ ଚ୍ୟାଲେଞ୍ଜ ଇଜ୍ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ନା ଇନ୍ ରିଆକ୍ସନ୍ ଟୁ ଦିସ୍ ଯେତେବେଳେ ସୁବ୍ରମଣ୍ୟମ ସ୍ୱାମୀ ଏଇ କଥା କହୁଛି ଯେତେବେଳେ ଯୋଗୀ ଆଦିତ୍ୟନାଥ ଗୋଟେ କଥା କହୁଛି ତ ସେତେବେଳେ ତାର ରିଆକ୍ସନ୍ରେ କ'ଣ ହଉଛି ନା ମୋବିଲାଇଜେସନ୍ ଅନ୍ ଦି ବେସିସ୍ ଅଫ୍ କାଷ୍ଟ ରିଲିଜିୟସ୍ ଏଥିନିକ୍ ଗ୍ରୁପ୍ ଏମାନଙ୍କ ଭିତରେ ଗୋଟେ ମୋବିଲାଇଜେସନ୍ ଷ୍ଟାର୍ଟ ହଉଛି ରାଇଟ୍ ଅଲ୍ଟିମେଟଲି ସେଟା କ'ଣ ହଉଛି ନା ଇଟ୍ ରେଜଲ୍ଟ ଟୁ କମ୍ୟୁନାଲ୍ କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ କମ୍ୟୁନାଲ୍ ରାୟଟ୍ ଏଥିନିକ୍ କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ terrorism, you know, Dalit agitation, then religious conversion, then caste riots, so on and so forth. So, ee sabu problem guda heuchi, right? ତେଣୁ ଆମେ ଦେଖିଲେ କ'ଣ ଇଭିନ୍ ଆମେ ଦେଖିଲୁ ବିଜେପି ଆସିସାରିଲା ପରେ ଆମର ଯେଉଁ ଏଥିନିସିଟି ବା ଏଥିନିକ୍ କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ ଏଇଟା ଗୋଟେ ଅତି ଗୋଟେ ୟୁନୋ ଏଣ୍ଟାଗନିଷ୍ଟିକ ୟୁନୋ ଏଣ୍ଟାଗନିଷ୍ଟିକ ରୂପ ଧାରଣ କରିନେଲା ଇଟ୍ ଟୁକ୍ ଏ ଭେରି ଏଣ୍ଟାଗନିଷ୍ଟିକ ଫର୍ମ ଯଦି ଆମେ ଟିକେ ବ୍ୟାକ୍ କରିଯିବା କି ଆମେ ଯଦି ପଳେଇବା ସେ ଯେଉଁ ନେହେରୁ ବିହାନ ନେସନ୍ ବିଲ୍ଡିଂ ୟୁନୋ ପ୍ରୋଜେକ୍ଟକୁ ଯିବା କି ଯେତେବେଳେ ସେଇ ପ୍ରୋଜେକ୍ଟଟା ଅପରେଟ୍ କରୁଥିଲା ସେତେବେଳେ ଏଥିନିସିଟି ସହିତ କ'ଣ ହେଲା ତ ଟିକେ ଜାଣିବା ତା ଉପରେ ସୋ ଇନ୍ ଦି ଫେସ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଡେଭଲପମେଣ୍ଟାଲ ପ୍ରୋଜେକ୍ଟ ନେସନ୍ ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ ବିଲ୍ଡିଂ ୱାଜ୍ କଣ୍ଟେଷ୍ଟେଡ୍ ତେଣୁ ନେହେରୁ ଯେଉଁଟା ଭାବୁଥିଲେ, ଏଇଟା ତ ବିଜେପି କଥା ମୁଁ କହିଲି, ବିଜେପି ଆସିସାରିଲା ପରେ କଲଚରାଲ ନେସନାଲିଜିମ୍ ଏଗେନଷ୍ଟରେ ଗୋଟେ ଆଣ୍ଟାଗନିଷ୍ଟିକ୍ ଆଇଡେଣ୍ଟିଟି ପଲିଟିକ୍ସ ଷ୍ଟାର୍ଟ ହେଲା, ୟୁ ନୋ, ରୁଥଲେସ୍ ଆଇଡେଣ୍ଟିଟି ପଲିଟିକ୍ସ, ଆଣ୍ଟାଗନିଷ୍ଟିକ୍ ଆଇଡେଣ୍ଟିଟି ପଲିଟିକ୍ସ, ୱି ଆର୍ ନଟ୍ ଆଡଭର୍ସରି, ୱି ଆର୍ ଜଷ୍ଟ ଏନିମି। ବିଜେପି ଆସିସାରିଲା ପରେ ଏଇଟା ହେଲା। ଟିକେ ଆମେ ପୂର୍ବକୁ ଯିବା, ପୂର୍ବରେ କ'ଣ ହେଲା, ନେହେରୁ ଭାବୁଥିଲେ କ'ଣ କି ଡେମୋକ୍ରାସି ଆଉ ଡେଭଲପମେଣ୍ଟ ଏଇ ଦୁଇଟା ଯାକ ଜିନିଷ ପରବର୍ତ୍ତୀ ସମୟରେ କ'ଣ କରିବ ନା, ଏଥିନିକ ଗ୍ରୁପ ଭିତରେ ଯାହା କିଛି ଡାଇଭର୍ସିଟି ଅଛି, ବିଭିନ୍ନତା ଅଛି, ସେ ବିଭିନ୍ନତାକୁ ସାଟିସ୍ଫାଏ କରିବ ଆଉ ସେ ବିଭିନ୍ନତା ଏକ ହେଇକି ରହିବେ। ମାନେ ଦି ଅଲ୍ ଦିସ୍ ଡାଇଭର୍ସ ଗ୍ରୁପ ଦେ ୱିଲ୍ ଫିଲ୍ ଦି ଦି କାଇଣ୍ଡ ଦି ଦି କନସେପ୍ଟ ଅଫ ୟୁନିଟି ଏଣ୍ଡ ସେମାନେ ସମସ୍ତେ ଭାରତ ସହିତ ଯୋଡ଼ିକି ରହିବେ। କିନ୍ତୁ ନେହେରୁଙ୍କର ବି ଏଇ ଯେଉଁ ନେହେରୁ ଅଭିଯାନ ପ୍ରୋଜେକ୍ଟ ବା ଡେଭଲପମେଣ୍ଟ ପ୍ରୋଜେକ୍ଟ ଏଇଟା ବି କାମ କଲା ନାହିଁ। ଆକୁ ବି ଲୋକ ତାର ଭେରି ଏଜମ୍ପସନକୁ ଦ ପ୍ରିମାଇସ୍ ଅଫ ଡେଭଲପମେଣ୍ଟ ପ୍ରୋଜେକ୍ଟ ଇଟ୍ ୱାଜ୍ କୋଶ୍ଚେନ୍ଡ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଇଟ୍ ୱାଜ୍ ଆର୍ଗ୍ୟୁଡ଼୍ ଦେଟ୍ କିଏ ଆର୍ଗ୍ୟୁଡ଼୍ କଲେ ନା, ମାର୍ଜିନାଲାଇଜଡ଼୍ କାଟେଗୋରୀ ବା ଏଥିନିକ ଗ୍ରୁପ, ଏଥିନିକ କମ୍ୟୁନିଟି, ସେମାନେ ଆର୍ଗ୍ୟୁ କଲେ କ'ଣ ନା, ଡେଭଲପମେଣ୍ଟ ମଡେଲ ଇଗ୍ନୋର ସ୍ମଲର ନେସନାଲିଟିଜ୍। ତା ମାନେ ତୁମେ ଯେଉଁ ଡେଭଲପମେଣ୍ଟ ପ୍ରୋଜେକ୍ଟ ଆମକୁ ଆଣିକି ଦେଖାଉଛ, ଆ ଦ୍ୱାରା ତ ତୁମେ ଆମର ନେସନାଲିଟି, ଆମର ଆଇଡେଣ୍ଟିଟିକୁ ନଷ୍ଟ କରିଦେଉଛ, ଆମର କଲଚର ଠାରୁ ଆମକୁ ଦୂରକୁ ନେଇ ନେଉଛ। ତମେ ତ ଆମକୁ ଗୋଟେ ଲିବରାଲ ଇକୋନୋମି ସହିତ ଆଇଡେଣ୍ଟିଫାଏ କରୁଛ, କିନ୍ତୁ ଆମର ଯେଉଁ ଗୋଟେ ଓନ୍ ଆଇଡେଣ୍ଟିଟି ଅଛି, ସେ ଆଇଡେଣ୍ଟିଟିକୁ କାହିଁକି ତମେ ରେସପଣ୍ଡ କରୁନାହ, କାହିଁକି ତମେ ଆମକୁ ଗୋଟେ ପ୍ରକାରର ଏସିମିଲେସନ ଆଡ଼କୁ ନେଇଯାଉଛ। ଇଫ୍ ୟୁ ରିମେମ୍ବର, ହ୍ୱେଦର ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏସିମିଲେସନ ଅର୍ ଡିସ୍କ୍ରିମିନେସନ, ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଆକ୍ଚୁଆଲି ଦି ରିଜିନ୍ ଅଫ୍ ମାର୍ଜିନାଲାଇଜେସନ। ତେଣୁ ମାର୍ଜିନାଲାଇଜେସନର ଦୁଇଟା ରୂପ ଅଛି, ଗୋଟେ ଡିସ୍କ୍ରିମିନେସନର ରୂପ ଅଛି, ଗୋଟେ ଏସିମିଲେସନର ଏଇନ ରୂପ ଅଛି। ଦେର୍ ଆର୍ ଟୁ କାଇଣ୍ଡ ଅଫ୍ ମାର୍ଜିନାଲାଇଜେସନ, ମାର୍ଜିନାଲାଇଜେସନ ଇନ୍ ଦି ଫର୍ମ ଅଫ୍ ୟୁନ ଡିଫରେନ୍ସିଏସନ ଅର୍ ଏ କାଇଣ୍ଡ ଅଫ୍ ଏସିମିଲେସନ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଡିସ୍କ୍ରିମିନେସନ, ଦୁଇ ପ୍ରକାରର ମାର୍ଜିନାଲାଇଜେସନ ଅଛି। ଏଠି ସେମାନେ କ'ଣ କ୍ୱେଶ୍ଚିନ୍ ପୁଟ୍ କଲେ ନା, ତୁମ ଡେଭଲପମେଣ୍ଟ ପ୍ରୋଜେକ୍ଟ କି ଆମକୁ ଏସିମିଲେଟ୍ କରିବା ପାଇଁ ଚାହୁଁଛି, ଆମକୁ ଆମର ଆଇଡେଣ୍ଟି ଠାରୁ ଦୂରେଇ ନେବା ପାଇଁ ଚାହୁଁଛି। ସୋ ଇଟ୍ ୱାଜ୍ ଏନ୍ ଇମ୍ପୋଜିସନ ଅନ୍ ଆସ୍, ଆମ ଉପରେ ତୁମେ ଏଟା ଇମ୍ପୋଜ୍ କରୁଛ, ଆମକୁ ତୁମେ ଫ୍ରିଡମ୍ ଦଉନ, ରାଇଟ୍? ଆଣ୍ଡ ଦେ ଆର୍ ଆଇଡେଣ୍ଟିଟି, କଲଚର, ହିଷ୍ଟ୍ରି, ଏସ୍ପାରେସନ ୱାଜ୍ ନେଗ୍ଲେକ୍ଟେଡ଼। ତେଣୁ ମୋର ଯେଉଁ ଆଇଡେଣ୍ଟିଟି ଅଛି, ମୋର ଯେଉଁ କଲଚର, ହିଷ୍ଟ୍ରି, ମୋର ଯେଉଁ ଏସ୍ପାରେସନ ଅଛି, ତୁମର ଡେଭଲପମେଣ୍ଟ ପ୍ରୋଜେକ୍ଟ ତାକୁ ନେଗ୍ଲେକ୍ଟ କରୁଛି। ତୁମର ଡେଭଲପମେଣ୍ଟ ପ୍ରୋଜେକ୍ଟ ମୋ ବିଷୟରେ ଯେଉଁ କଥା କହୁଛି, ସେ କଥାଟା ମୋ ପାଇଁ ସମ୍ପୂର୍ଣ୍ଣ ନୂଆ। ମୋର ଯେଉଁ ମୋ ବିଷୟରେ ଯେଉଁ ଗୋଟେ ପ୍ରକାରର ୟୁନୋ କଲଚର ଅଛି, ୟୁନୋ ମୋର ଯେଉଁ ଗୋଟେ ଆଇଡେଣ୍ଟିଟି ଅଛି, ହିଷ୍ଟ୍ରି ଅଛି, ଏସ୍ପାରେସନ ଅଛି, ଆ ଉପରେ ତୁମ ଡେଭଲପମେଣ୍ଟ ପ୍ରୋଜେକ୍ଟ କିଛି କହୁନି, ରାଇଟ୍? ସୋ ଇନଫ୍ୟାକ୍ଟ ଦିସ୍ ଡେଭଲପମେଣ୍ଟ ମଡେଲ ଅଫ୍ ନେସନ ବିଲ୍ଡିଂ ୱାଜ୍ ଏଣ୍ଟିଥେଟିକାଲ ଟୁ ଆୱାର ଇଣ୍ଟରେଷ୍ଟ। ତେଣୁ ଏଥିନିସିଟି ବା ଏଥିନିକ କମ୍ୟୁନିଟି, ଯେଉଁମାନଙ୍କ ଭିତରେ ଗୋଟେ ନିଜ ଗୋଟେ ପ୍ରକାରର ନେସନାଲିଟି ବା ନେସନାଲିଜିମ୍ ଥିଲା, ସେମାନେ ଏଇ ଡେଭଲପମେଣ୍ଟ ପ୍ରୋଜେକ୍ଟକୁ ତାର ଭେରି ବେସିସ୍କୁ ଚ୍ୟାଲେଞ୍ଜ କରିବାକୁ ଲାଗିଲେ। ତେଣୁ ନେହେରୁ ଯେଉଁ ଭାବୁଥିଲେ କି ଏଣ୍ଟାୟାର ୟୁରୋପ ବା ଆମେରିକାକୁ ଆଣିକି ପୁରା ଇଣ୍ଡିଆରେ ଏଷ୍ଟାବ୍ଲିଶ କରିଦେବେ, ଇଣ୍ଡିଆ ବାଲା କ'ଣ କଲେ ନା, ଇଏ ନେହେରୁକୁ ୟୁନୋ ଦେ ଗେଭ୍ ଦି ଚ୍ୟାଲେଞ୍ଜ ଅଫ୍ ଡାଇଭର୍ସିଟି। ତେଣୁ ଗୋଟେ ପଟେ ନେହେରୁ ୟୁନୋ ଇମ୍ପୋଜିଂ ଏ କାଇଣ୍ଡ ଅଫ୍ ୟୁନୋ ଆଇ ୱିଲ୍ ସେ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏ ଏଥେଇଷ୍ଟିକ ମୋଡ୍ ଅଫ୍ ସେକୁଲାରିଜିମ୍ ଅନ୍ ଦେମ୍। ଅନ୍ ଦି ଅଦର ସାଇଡ୍ ଦେ ଆର୍ ୟୁନୋ ଗିଭିଂ ଏ ରେସ୍ପନ୍ସ ଅନ୍ ଦି ବେସିସ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଡାଇଭର୍ସିଟି, ରାଇଟ୍? ସୋ ଦିସ୍ ୱାଜ୍ the challenge of ethnic community to the development project. In contrast to this contestation of ethnic community against the development project, Paul R. Brass is a sociologist. He argued that there is nothing wrong in the developmental model of managing ethnicity, because in principle pluralist character of its policy has been accepted. ତାହେଲେ ପଲ୍ ବ୍ରାସ୍ କ'ଣ କହୁଛନ୍ତି କି ନେହେରୁ ଭିଆନ୍ ଯେଉଁ ଡେଭଲପମେଣ୍ଟ ପ୍ରୋଜେକ୍ଟ, ଯାହାକୁ ତୁମେ କହୁଛ ଗୋଟେ ହେଜିମୋନିକ୍ ସେକୁଲାରିଜିମ୍ କହୁଛ, ଆକ୍ଚୁଆଲି ଏଇଟା ହେଜିମୋନିକ୍ ସେକୁଲାରିଜିମ୍ ନୁହଁ। ତୁମେ ଯଦି ତାର ପ୍ରିନ୍ସିପଲ୍କୁ ଯାଇକି ଦେଖିବ, ଯେମିତିକି ଆମ କନଷ୍ଟିଟ୍ୟୁସନ୍ଟା, ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ନଟ୍ ଆଣ୍ଟି ମାଇନୋରିଟି, बट आम स्टेट एंटी माइनोरीटी होचे जदि आम स्टेट टा कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन द्वारा गाइडेड होचे कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनली आम स्टेट जदि ठीक अछि आम स्टेट काई एंटी माइनोरीटी ही पर हे जाउचे राइट किंतु आम कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन एंटी माइनोरीटी नो पॉल ब्रास एक कथा कहले कि जदि तुम्हें नेहरू रो यू नो तंग डेवलपमेंट प्रोजेक्ट को तुम्हें जदि टिके अनुध्यान करिवो तो तुम्हें सेठी देखिबा पई पाइबो कि द प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ प्लुरालिज्म इज द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक फीचर राइट तेणु आम आम एथनिसीटी को कनसीडर करूँ केरल जो डेवलपमेंट प्रोजेक्ट आम करा करूँ कारण केरल लोक अलग ओडार लोक अलग कि कौन प्रोब्लेम कौन हो बट द गवर्नमेंट ऑन द स्टेट स्टेट गवर्नमेंट फॉलोड द डिस्क्रिमिनेटरी और एसिमिलेटिव पॉलिसीज टुवर्ड्स द माइनॉरिटी किंतु एटी सी पॉल ब्रांच दोष देदेले कौन ना स्टेट को मानने कौन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ठीक अच्छी किंतु स्टेट खराब सेमिति पॉल ब्रास कहीदेले कि आमर डेवलपमेंट मॉडल टा ठीक अच्छी किंतु ताकु जो इम्प्लीमेंट जो इंस्टीट्यूशन करछन जो स्टेट एजेंसी करछि से स्टेट एजेंसी ताकु प्रॉपर्ली इम्प्लीमेंट करि पारु नाही तेणु आम देखिलु कौन जदि मानने कांग्रेस रिजिम हो कि बीजेपी रिजिम रे हो यू नो एथनिसिटी इज गिविंग ए रिप्लाय टू द डेवलपमेंट प्रोजेक्ट ऑफ नेहरू और कांग्रेस एंड इट इज ऑल्सो गिविंग ए रिप्लाय टू द कल्चरल नेशनलिज्म ऑफ बीजेपी तेणु आम कहीपर जमीक आईडेटिटी पॉलीटिक्स को मुझे कही फेथ एकम्प्ली तो सेमती भी मुझे एथनिक पॉलीटिक्स एथनिक कनफ्लिक्ट एथनिसीटी दैट इज अल्सो फेथ एकम्प्ली एथनिक कनफ्लिक्ट इज भेरी मच इंटरेस्टेड इन आस वी मे नॉट बी इंटरेस्टेड इन इट बट एक्चुअली वी ऑल बिलोंग टू वन काइंड ऑफ एथनिसीटी और अदर कॉन्शियसली और अनकॉन्शियसली वी आर ऑल अटैच टू ए काइंड or you know many kinds of ethnicity so I am a member of multiple ethnic you know group or category now let us move to the theories of ethnicity right so what is the theory of ethnicity there are mostly you know four theories of ethnicity the first theory is the primordialism or primordial theory of ethnicity Second theory is the modernization theory of ethnicity. Third is the Marxist theory of ethnicity. And fourth, it is the constructive theory of ethnicity. So what is this primordial theory of ethnicity? Now, to primordial theory of ethnicity, ethnicity or ethnic, it is something which is fixed. That means, it has a historical continuity it depends on blood it depends on language it depends on territory it depends on culture jo ta me cognitive level ami jo ta dekhu chi right jo mu tini ta feature kahitile ethnicity ne you know objective subjective behavioral objective ta hoche something jo ta me cognitive level le ami ta ko experience karu to primordial se kon kahuchi na jehetu mu gote rakta ko belong karuchi जेहेतु मु इनो गोटे प्रकार लांगुएज को बिलंग करुची जेहेतु मु गोटे प्रकार टेरिटोरी को बिलंग करुची कल्चर को बिलंग करुची तेणु मोर आइडेंटिटी बा मोर एथनिसिटी एटा होची मोर फिक्स्ड इफ आई एम ओडिया आई एम डिफरेंट फ्रॉम नॉन ओडिया इफ आई एम ब्राह्मीन देन आई एम डिफरेंट टू दलित इफ आई एम दलित देन आई एम डिफरेंट टू ब्राह्मीन राइट सो इफ आई बिलोंग टू इंडिया देन आई एम नॉट नॉन इंडिया आई एम नॉट ए पाकिस्तानी And this, my identity of Indian, identity of Brahmin, identity of Odia, these are fixed to me. And our, all these ethnicity or ethnic identity or ethnic community, they are based on a fixed, boundary or fixed conception, a fixed understanding. That is the primordial. That is something which is fixed. It is fixed because there is a objective feature attached to you and you are related to that objective feature then the modernization theory of ethnicity what is modernization theory of ethnicity now according to it now the ethnicity is the product of modernization theory for example with the emergence of industry capitalism media migration you know ethnicity it began right And how ethnicity began? Now, if you see the capitalism or industry or media, then you can find an invisible, you know, exploitator is exploiting. And the powerless is becoming more powerless. The powerful is becoming more powerful. Then people are also migrating from their, you know, primordial identity. माने मु काम करिबा पई मते सूरत जिबा पई पड़छि मो ओडिसा रे काम पाउनी त सेतबेले कोन होउछि ना मु मोर प्राइमोडियल आइडेंटिटी रु मु दूर को जिबा पई मु दूर को जाउछि काम अन्वेषण रे जोंटा के हमें कहउछि माइग्रेशन तो ए सब हबा फल रे एथनिसिटी टा क्रिएट होउछि जेमिति इंडस्ट्री कैपिटलिज्म पई कोन एथनिसिटी क्रिएट ना कोन कोन एथनिसिटी क्रिएट हला ना प्रोलेटेरिएट प्रोलेटेरिएट क्लास एज ए एथनिसिटी community or proletariat have not class jo ta ame koche now have not class ta ko uthu asila seta kon aguru thila have not class ta na e class ta asila amaro sei jo capitalism pai tanu capitalism pai jo amaro asila proletariat class ta asila that proletariat class is because or that proletariat class is one kind of ethnicity one kind of ethnic group and that group it is because of this modernization थियोरी राइट इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन परे परे बहुत गुड़ा एथनिसीटी आम पाक आसल देन द मार्क्सिस्ट थियोरी ऑफ एथनिसीटी मार्क्सिस्ट थियोरी ऑफ एथनिसीटी कौन कहूँ ना एथनिसीटी इज ए फॉर्म ऑफ फॉल्स कॉन्शियसनेस व्हिच विल बी रिप्लेस्ड बाय ए क्लास कॉन्शियसनेस मार्क्स कौन कौन यू हैव एवरीवेयर यू आर इन चेन यू हैव नथिंग टू लूज बट योर चेन दैट मीन्स दैट आम जो कहे मल्टीपुल एथनिसीटी अच्छी मल्टीपुल एथनिसीटी भितर किसी कमनालीटीज अच्छी से कमनालीटीज कौन ना वी रिप्रेजेंट द पावरलेसनेस राइट तो एज लॉन्ग एज वी विल बी डिवाइडेड इनटू मल्टीपुल एथनिसीटी राइट देन वी आर लिविंग इन ए फुल्स पाराडाइज वी आर लिविंग इन ए फॉल्स कॉन्शियसनेस जदि एक छोट छोट एथनिक ग्रुप भितर गोटे प्रकार बंडेज न आसब कनेक्शन न आसब तेब जाने एलिट सहित इनो इनो फाइट करें ना से गोटे सिस्टम को चेंज करें ना योगेन्द्र यादव भी इनो तर सोशल जस्टिस कनसेप्ट भी सी हि एज गिवेन सच काइंड अफ कनसेपन अल्सो सो फ्रम मार्क्सिस्ट अंडरस्टाणिंग अफ एथनिसीटी इनो दर इज ए नीड of conversion there is a need of conversion from a false consciousness to class consciousness that is the marxist theory of ethnicity then the constructive theory of ethnicity is just opposed to the primordial theory of ethnicity and to constructive theory ethnicity is not fixed it is evolving it is changing even cultural features evolve from one period to another it is a product of human interaction that means ame jodi chinta kariba aji brahman au dalit bhitre jo prakar ra gute ethnic diversity amo bhitre achi kon sei diversity ta amo man ko jeja bapa ko samay re thila ba tanko bapa ko samay re thila na but group thile ये दलित थिला सी ब्राह्मण थिला आज भी ये दलित सी भी ब्राह्मण किंतु लुक एट द रिलेशन बिटवीन द दलित एंड ब्राह्मण तेणु आम ये देखुचे कौन द एथनिसिटी और द काइंड ऑफ यू नो बिहेवियरल रिलेशन सेटा परमानेंट नुह आम जेजामा समय जहाँ बिहेवियरल रिलेशन थिला ब्राह्मण दलित भितर आज आम भितर से प्रकार रिलेशन ना तेणु कन्स्ट्रक्टिविज्म कौन कहूँ ना एथनिसीटी इज कन्स्ट्रक्टेड विथ दि पासिंग अफ टाइम तेणु एथनिसीटी फिक्स्ड नुह समय अनुसार एथनिसीटी भितर गोटे प्रकार इवल्वमेंट चली तेणु आज ब्राह्मण दलित भितर जहाँ रिलेसन अच्छी हूं तो आम पिला मैंने आसला बेलू भितर रिलेसन गोटे कि अलग मोड को जीव कहीं एक कहे कारण एथनिसीटी मुझे जो डिफाइन करी थ्री फीचर्स द बिहेवियरल फीचर को जब तुम्हें मन पकेबो देन यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड दिस पॉइंट तेणु एथनिसीटी टा फिक्स्ड नुह अकॉर्डिंग टू द कंस्ट्रक्टिव थ्योरी ऑफ एथनिसीटी इट इज evolving, it is changing from one time to another time, from one period to another period, and this is the product of human interaction, jo name behavioral feature kahilu. And ethnicity, it is also the product of human interaction, right? Now let us talk about what are the conditions in which this ethnic movement emerge. कौन कौन कंडीशन ले एथनिक मूवमेंट टा एमर्ज करे राइट बट ता पूर्वरो बिफोर वी कम टू द नेसेसरी कंडीशन ऑफ एथनिक मूवमेंट लेट अस यू नो स्पेंड सम टाइम ऑन द टाइप्स ऑफ एथनिक मूवमेंट और एथनिक कॉन्फ्लिक्ट राइट देयर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ एथनिक कॉन्फ्लिक्ट वन इज द वर्टिकल एथनिक कॉन्फ्लिक्ट अनदर इज द हॉरिजॉन्टल एथनिक कॉन्फ्लिक्ट व्हाट इज अ वर्टिकल एथनिक कॉन्फ्लिक्ट In that conflict, the ethnic group, ethnic community is against the state. They are simply against the state. For example, ame kon nahi pariba, na ame nahi pariba northeast re jo ethnic conflict chali chi. For example, ame nahi pariba Kashmir re jo ethnic conflict chali chi. To sei dita jako conflict ame dekhiba kon the ethnic conflict is because they are not satisfied with the state. They are demanding more and more from the state. They are unhappy about the state. Hence, they want to secede from the state. So that is something, a vertical ethnic conflict. And the main purpose of vertical ethnic conflict, let me take some water. The main purpose of vertical ethnic conflict is the autonomy movement. It is demand for secession, as I said earlier, right? We are different, so we do not want to stay to the Indian state. Indian state has forcibly, you know, put us in their category. We don't think that we are Indian. We want a separate state, right? तेणु भर्टिकल एथनिक मूवमेंट रे आम केवल नॉर्थ ईस्ट मूवमेंट को नवानी आम काश्मीर मूवमेंट को नवानी आम इवेन यो द्राविड़नाडु राइट यो द्राविडियन मूवमेंट साउथ रे से मूवमेंट को भी आम नहीं पारा राइट सो व्हाट इज द फीचर्स ऑफ दिस भर्टिकल एथनिक मूवमेंट ना भर्टिकल एथनिक कॉन्फ्लिक्ट और मूवमेंट इज बेस्ड ऑन सेल्फ डिटर्मिनेशन मूवमेंट सेल्फ डिटर्मिनेशन दैट मीन्स India is other to us. India is not my state. If you remember Kashmir, the Kashmir loko kon kahanti? Indian government is a different government. We are having a different government. We are not Indian. We are first Kashmir, then Indian. Right? So this vertical ethnic conflict is based on self-determination. Same language. Tame northeast re bhi paibo, same language. तमें यू नो द्राविड़नाडु भी पाइब राइट द्राविड़नाडु सेमती किसी है ही नहीं बट से चाहूँ गोटे द्राविड़नाडु करने राइट सो इट इज ए इमाजिंड एथनिक कम्युनिटी जोटा एंडरसन कहते इमाजिंड कम्युनिटी फ्रॉम दैट सेंस आई एम सेइंग सो द्राविड़नाडु इट्स नॉट ए यू नो लीगल नेम ऑफ ए पर्टिकुलर टेरिटोरी इट्स ए वेरी मोर साइकोलॉजिकल राइट सो द फर्स्ट फीचर ऑफ vertical ethnic conflict is based on self determination second this form of conflict do not follow the unique sequence of occurrence that means look at kashmir vertical ethnic conflict look at dravidnadu ethnic conflict look at northeast ethnic conflict Are those ethnic conflicts same? No, they are not same because they are different in different situation. तनु vertical ethnic conflict रा गोटे typical you know shape नहीं, तारु डे typical you know framework नहीं. ये बहुत उड़ा रूपो नहीं परे vertical ethnic conflict, right? That is the second feature. Third. Now this may start with one form and assume another form in different situation. Tamani eta gote ru arambh hue ଆଉ ଗୋଟେ ଯାଇକି ଶେଷ ହେଇଥାଏ ସେଟା ତୁମେ ଦ୍ରାବିଡ଼ିଆନ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟକୁ ତମେ ଆରମ୍ଭ କରିବ ସେମାନେ ସେମାନେ ଲାଙ୍ଗୁଏଜରୁ ଆରମ୍ଭ କଲେ ସେମାନେ ଲାଙ୍ଗୁଏଜରୁ ଆରମ୍ଭ କଲେ କିନ୍ତୁ ତାଙ୍କର ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟର ଲାଷ୍ଟ ପର୍ପଜ କ'ଣ ରହିଲା ନା ଟୁ କ୍ରିଏଟ୍ ଏ ଦ୍ରାବିଡ଼ ନଡ଼ ତେଣୁ ଦିସ୍ ଭର୍ଟିକାଲ ଏଥନିକ କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ ଇଟ୍ ଷ୍ଟାର୍ଟସ୍ ୱିଥ୍ ୱାନ୍ ଫର୍ମ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଏଜ୍ୟୁମ୍ସ ଏନଦର ଫର୍ମ ଇନ୍ ଡିଫରେଣ୍ଟ ସିଚୁଏସନ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଦିସ୍ ଭର୍ଟିକାଲ ଏଥନିକ କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ ଇଟ୍ ଇନକ୍ଲୁଡ୍ସ ଡିମାଣ୍ଡ ଫର୍ ଅଟୋନମି ସେସେସନ୍ ଫ୍ରମ୍ ୟୁନିଅନ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଇଟ୍ ଅଫନ୍ ରେଜଲ୍ଟ ଭାଓଲେନ୍ସ ତମେ ଯଦି ଟିକେ ମନେ ପକେଇବ ତେଲେଙ୍ଗାନା ଏ ଯୋଉ ଆମର ତେଲେଙ୍ଗାନା ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ଟା ତିଆରି ହେଲା ସେତେବେଳେ ମୁଁ ହାଇଦ୍ରାବାଦରେ ମୋର ଏମ୍ଫିଲ୍ଟେ କରୁଥାଏ ଏମ୍ଏନ୍ ଏମ୍ଫିଲ୍ କ'ଣ କରୁଥାଏ ତ ସେତେବେଳେ ହାଇଦ୍ରାବାଦରେ ଗୋଟେ ଓସମାନିଆ ୟୁନିଭର୍ସିଟିର ଗୋଟେ ଷ୍ଟୁଡେଣ୍ଟଟେ ସେ ନିଜ ଉପରେ ପେଟ୍ରୋଲ ଢାଲିକି ନିଆଁ ଲଗେଇଦେଲା ନା ଏଇ ଯୋଉ ନିଆଁ ଜଳେଇ ଦେବାଟା ଏଇ ଯୋଉ ସେଲ୍ଫ ଭାଓଲେସନ୍ ଇମୋସନ୍ ସେଟା କହନ୍ତି ବା ସୁଇସାଇଡ୍ କହନ୍ତି ନା ସୁଇସାଇଡ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏ ଗ୍ରେଟର ଭାଓଲେନ୍ସ ଅନ୍ୟକୁ ଜାଳି ଦେବାଟା ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଅଣ୍ଡରଷ୍ଟାଣ୍ଡେବୁଲ୍ ବଟ୍ ନିଜକୁ ଜାଳି ଦେବାଟା ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ସମଥିଙ୍ଗ ହୁଇଚ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏ ଡିପର ସେନ୍ସ ଡିପର ଫିଲୋସଫି ଆକୁ ଆମେ କହୁଛେ ଡିପର ଭାଓଲେନ୍ସ ରାଇଟ୍ ସୋ ତେଣୁ ଆମେ ଦେଖିଲେ କ'ଣ ଦି ଭର୍ଟିକାଲ ଯେଉଁ ଏଥନିକ କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ ରହୁଛି ଇଟ୍ କ୍ରିଏଟ୍ସ ଏ ଡିପର ଭାଓଲେନ୍ସ ଦେନ୍ ଦି ସେକେଣ୍ଡ କାଟେଗୋରୀ ଅଫ୍ ଏଥନିକ କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦି ହରାଇଜେଣ୍ଟାଲ କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ ହ୍ୱାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏ ହରାଇଜେଣ୍ଟାଲ କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ ନା ଦ ହରାଇଜେଣ୍ଟାଲ କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ ଇଜ୍ ଦି କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ ବିଟୱିନ୍ ଟୁ କମ୍ୟୁନିଟିଜ୍ କେମିତି ନା ଆମର ହିନ୍ଦୁ ମୁସଲିମ ଭାରତ ଭିତରେ ତାଙ୍କର ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ ସହିତ କିଛି ଫାଇଟିଂ ନାହିଁ ତାଙ୍କର ଇଣ୍ଟର କମ୍ୟୁନିଟି ଯେମିତି କନ୍ଧ ପାଣ ତାଙ୍କର ଇଣ୍ଟର କମ୍ୟୁନିଟି ଫାଇଟିଂ ଇଏ ବି ଗୋଟେ ପ୍ରକାରର ଏଥନିକ କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ ଆକୁ ଆମେ କହୁଛେ ହରାଇଜେଣ୍ଟାଲ ଏଥନିକ କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ ଏ କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟଟା କ'ଣ ହୁଏ ନା ଦ କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ ହ୍ୟାପେନ୍ସ ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ବିକଜ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଦି ପ୍ରେଜେନ୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ଅଦର ନାଓ ହିନ୍ଦୁମାନେ ମୁସଲମାନଙ୍କ ପ୍ରେଜେନ୍ସକୁ ଟଲରେଟ୍ କରିପାରୁନାହାନ୍ତି ମୁସଲମାନ ମାନେ ହିନ୍ଦୁ ପ୍ରେଜେନ୍ସକୁ ଟଲରେଟ୍ କରିପାରୁନାହାନ୍ତି କନ୍ଧ ମାନେ ପାଣର ପ୍ରେଜେନ୍ସକୁ ଟଲରେଟ୍ କରିପାରୁନାହାନ୍ତି କି ପାଣ ମାନେ କନ୍ଧର ପୋଜିସନକୁ ଟଲରେଟ୍ କରିପାରୁନାହାନ୍ତି ତେଣୁ ସିନ୍ସ ଦେର୍ ଆର୍ ପ୍ରେଜେନ୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ଅଦର ଦେର୍ ଇଜ୍ କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଦ ମେନ୍ ଟାର୍ଗେଟ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଦି ପ୍ରୋଟାଗନିଷ୍ଟ ଅଫ୍ ଦିସ୍ କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ ଇଜ୍ ଦି ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ ପାୱାର ତେଣୁ ଯେଉଁମାନେ ଏଇ ପ୍ରକାରର କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ କରନ୍ତି ହିନ୍ଦୁ ମୁସଲିମକୁ ନେଇକି କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ କରନ୍ତି କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ ତ ହୁଏ ଏଇ ଯୋଉ ଆମେ କହୁଛେ ହରାଇଜେଣ୍ଟାଲ କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟରେ ଦେର୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏ ପ୍ରୋଟାଗନିଷ୍ଟ ଜଣେ ନେପଥ୍ୟର ନାୟକ ଥାଏ ଯିଏକି ଏଇ କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟଟାକୁ କରଉଥାଏ ଇଭିନ୍ କନ୍ଧମାଳରେ ବି ନେପଥ୍ୟର ନାୟକ ଅଛନ୍ତି ଯେଉଁମାନେ କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟଟାକୁ କରେଇଛନ୍ତି ସେଇ ନେପଥ୍ୟର ନାୟକମାନଙ୍କର ଗୋଟେ କେବଳ ଉଦ୍ଦେଶ୍ୟ ଥାଏ ସେ ଉଦ୍ଦେଶ୍ୟ ହେଉଛି କ'ଣ କ୍ୟାପଚରିଂ ଦି ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ ପାୱାର ସୋ ବ୍ରଡ଼ଲି ଦିଜ୍ ଆର୍ ଦି ଟୁ ଡିଫରେଣ୍ଟ ଟାଇପ୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ଏଥନିକ କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ ନାଓ ଲେଟ୍ ମି କମ୍ ଟୁ ଦି କଣ୍ଡିସନ୍ ଇନ୍ ଦି ଏଥନିକ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟ ହ୍ୱାଟ୍ ଆର୍ ଦ ପ୍ରି କଣ୍ଡିସନ୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ଏଥନିକ କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ ଅର୍ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟ ଦ ପ୍ରି କଣ୍ଡିସନ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଏଥନିକ କ'ଣ କ'ଣ ଗୋଟେ ଏଥନିକ କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ ହେବା ପାଇଁ କ'ଣ କ'ଣ ଦରକାର ନା ପ୍ରଥମେ କ'ଣ ଦରକାର ନା କନ୍ସିୟସ୍ ଏଥନିକ କମ୍ୟୁନିଟି କନ୍ସିୟସ୍ ଏଥନିକ କମ୍ୟୁନିଟି ମିନ୍ସ ଖାଲି ଏଥନିକ କମ୍ୟୁନିଟି ରହିଗଲେ ହେବନି ତାଙ୍କ ଭିତରେ ଗୋଟେ ପ୍ରକାରର କନ୍ସିୟସ୍ନେସ୍ ଆସିବ କେଉଁ କନ୍ସିୟସ୍ନେସ୍ ଇଫ୍ ୟୁ ରିମେମ୍ବର ମାର୍କ୍ସ କାର୍ଲ ମାର୍କ୍ସ କେମିତି ଗୋଟେ ପ୍ରକାରର କନ୍ସିୟସ୍ନେସ୍ ଡେଭଲପ୍ କରିଥିଲେ ୱାର୍କିଂ କ୍ଲାସ୍ ଭିତରେ ତେବେ ତ ଯାଇକି ରିଭଲ୍ୟୁସନ୍ଟା ପସିବୁଲ୍ ହେଲା ତେଣୁ ସେଇ କନ୍ସିୟସ୍ନେସ୍ଟା ଥିବା ଦରକାର କନ୍ସିୟସ୍ନେସ୍ କ'ଣ କେତେବେଳେ କନ୍ସିୟସ୍ନେସ୍ ଆସିବ ନା ଯେତେବେଳେ ଆମେ ପ୍ରଶ୍ନ ପଚାରିବା ହୁ ଆର୍ ୱି ହ୍ୱାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଆୱାର୍ ପର୍ପୋଜ୍ ଏଇ ଦୁଇଟା ପ୍ରଶ୍ନ ଇଫ୍ ୟୁ ୱିଲ୍ ଆସ୍କ ଟୁ ୟୋର୍ ସେଲ୍ଫ ଦେନ୍ ୟୁ ୱିଲ୍ ଗେଟ୍ ଏ କାଇଣ୍ଡ ଅଫ୍ କନ୍ସିୟସ୍ନେସ୍ without asking this question then you are not a conscious ethnic community tano gote communal aba gote ethnic conflict pai by ethnic movement pai prathame darkar conscious ethnic community ditiyare kon darkar na sense of discrimination and deprivation ta mane tuma bhitre gote perception rahiba darkar ki amaku discriminate kara jaichi ଆମ ଏଗେନଷ୍ଟରେ ଆମେ ଡିପ୍ରାଇଭ୍ଡ ହେଇଛୁ ଆମେ ଡିସ୍କ୍ରିମିନେଟ୍ ହେଇଛୁ ଏମ୍ ଆଇ ଅଡିଏବୁଲ୍
ହ୍ୟାଲୋ
ଓକେ ଓକେ ସୋ ସେକେଣ୍ଡଟା କ'ଣ ସେକେଣ୍ଡ କଣ୍ଡିସନ୍ଟା କ'ଣ ପ୍ରି କଣ୍ଡିସନ୍ ଗୋଟେ ଏଥନିକ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟ ହବ ପାଇଁ ନା ସେନ୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ଡିସ୍କ୍ରିମିନେସନ୍ ଡିପ୍ରାଇଭେସନ୍ କି ଆମ ପ୍ରତି ଡିପ୍ରାଇଭେସନ୍ ହେଇଛି ଆମ ଏଗେନଷ୍ଟରେ ଡିସ୍କ୍ରିମିନେସନ୍ ହେଇଛି ଆଟଲିଷ୍ଟ ଏଇ ପରସେପ୍ସନ୍ଟା ରହିବା ଦରକାର ନା ପରସେପ୍ସନ୍ଟା ଖାଲିଟାରେ ଆସେନି ସଦାବେଳେ ମଣିଷର ପରସେପ୍ସନ୍ଟା ତାର ଏକ୍ଜିଷ୍ଟେନ୍ସ ସହିତ ରିଲେଟେଡ୍ ହେଇଥାଏ ନିଶ୍ଚିତ କିଛି ତ ଗୋଟେ ଘଟଣା ଘଟିଥିବ ଯୋଉଠୁ ଜଣେ ଏଇ ପରସେପ୍ସନଟା ପାଉଛି, ତେଣୁ ନିଶ୍ଚିତ ଯେତେବେଳେ ଜଣେ ଡିସ୍କ୍ରିମିନେଟ୍ ଫିଲ୍ କରୁଛି, ଡିପ୍ରାଇଭେସନ୍ ଫିଲ୍ କରୁଛି, ନିଶ୍ଚିତ କିଛି ତ ଗୋଟେ ଘଟଣା ତାର ମେଟେରିଆଲ ୱାର୍ଲ୍ଡରେ ଘଟିଥିବ, ବା କିଛି ତ ଗୋଟେ ଭୁଲ ବୁଝାମଣା ତା ମାଇଣ୍ଡ ଭିତରେ ପଶିଥିବ ଯେଉଁଥିପାଇଁ କି ତା ଭିତରେ ଏଇ ସେନ୍ସଟା ଡେଭଲପ୍ କରୁଛି। ବଟ୍ ଦିସ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦି ସେକେଣ୍ଡ ପ୍ରି କଣ୍ଡିସନ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଏଥନିକ ଇଣ୍ଟେଲେକ୍ଚୁଆଲ। ଏଥିକାଲ ଇଣ୍ଟେଲେକ୍ଚୁଆଲ କ'ଣ? ଏଥନିକ, ସରି, ଏଥନିକ ଇଣ୍ଟେଲେକ୍ଚୁଆଲ, ତା ମାନେ ଗୋଟେ ଏଥନିକ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟ ହେବା ପାଇଁ ତାର ଏଥନିକ ଇଣ୍ଟେଲେକ୍ଚୁଆଲ୍ସ ମାନେ ଥିବା ଦରକାର। ଯେମିତି ସବଲଟନ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟ ପାଇଁ ସବଲଟନ ମାନଙ୍କର ଥିଓରିଷ୍ଟ ଅଛନ୍ତି, ମଲ୍ଟିକଲଚରାଲିଜିମ ପାଇଁ ମଲ୍ଟିକଲଚରାଲ ଲୋକ ତାଙ୍କର ଇନୋ ଥିଓରିଷ୍ଟ ଅଛନ୍ତି। ତେଣୁ ସେଇ ଇଣ୍ଟେଲେକ୍ଚୁଆଲ ବା ଏଥନିକ ଇଣ୍ଟେଲେକ୍ଚୁଆଲ ମାନଙ୍କର କାମ କ'ଣ ନା, ଦେ ଗିଭ୍ ଜଷ୍ଟିଫିକେସନ, ଲଜିକାଲ ଜଷ୍ଟିଫିକେସନ ଏଲଙ୍ଗ ୱିଥ୍ ପଲିଟିକାଲ ଏଲିଟ। ତେଣୁ ଜଣେ ଦୁଇଟା ଦୁଇ ଜଣ ରହୁଛନ୍ତି ଏଥନିକ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟର, ଜଣେ ଗ୍ରାସ ରୁଟ୍ରେ କାମ କରୁଛି, ଯିଏ କାମ କରୁଛି ସେ ପଲିଟିକାଲ ଏଲିଟ, ଏଥନିକ କମ୍ୟୁନିଟିରୁ ସେ ବିଲଙ୍ଗ କରୁଛି, ଆଉ ଜଣେ ରହୁଛି ତାର କ'ଣ ନା ଇଣ୍ଟେଲେକ୍ଚୁଆଲ ଫାଦର ରହୁଛି। ତେଣୁ ଇଣ୍ଟେଲେକ୍ଚୁଆଲ ଫାଦର ମାନେ କ'ଣ କରୁଛନ୍ତି, ୟୁ ନୋ, ସେମାନେ ଗୋଟେ ପ୍ରକାରର ଲଜିକାଲ ଜଷ୍ଟିଫିକେସନ ଦେଉଛନ୍ତି, ତାଦ୍ୱାରା ଏଥନିକ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟ ପ୍ରୋଗ୍ରେସ କରୁଛି, ରାଇଟ? ହ୍ୟାଲୋ ହ୍ୟାଲୋ
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Continue. Please continue.
ଓକେ 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 ଦ ଫୋର୍ଥ ଫିଚର ଇଜ୍ ଦି କମ୍ପିଟିସନ ଟୁ ଗ୍ରାବ ଦି ପଲିଟିକାଲ ପାୱାର, ଯେଉଁଟା ଆମେ ହରାଇଜେଣ୍ଟାଲ ଏଥନିକ କନଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟରେ ଦେଖିଲୁ କି କନ୍ଧ ପାଣ ଭିତରେ ଯେଉଁ ଝଗଡ଼ା ଲାଗିଛି, ମୁସଲମାନ ଆଉ ହିନ୍ଦୁ ଭିତରେ ଯେଉଁ ଗୋଟେ ପ୍ରକାରର ଏଥନିକ କନଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ ଅଛି, ତାର କେବଳ ଗୋଟେ ଉଦ୍ଦେଶ୍ୟ, ସେଇ ଉଦ୍ଦେଶ୍ୟଟା କ'ଣ ନା, ଏଥନିକ କନଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ ଦ୍ୱାରା ଯେଉଁମାନେ ଏଥନିକ କନଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ କରାଉଛନ୍ତି, ତ ତାଙ୍କର ଗୋଟେ ଇନୋ ପଲିଟିକାଲ ଲିଡର ହବାର, ପଲିଟିକାଲ ପାୱାର, ଗୋଟେ ମନ୍ତ୍ରୀଟେ ଗୋଟେ ମନ୍ତ୍ରୀଟେ ହବାର ଇଚ୍ଛା ଅଛି, ଗୋଟେ ପାର୍ଲିଆମେଣ୍ଟେରିଆନ ହବାର ଗୋଟେ ତାଙ୍କର ଇଚ୍ଛା ଅଛି, ରାଇଟ? ଦେନ୍ ଦେର୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏ ଡୋମିନୋ ଇଫେକ୍ଟ, ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଏଥନିକ ପଲିଟିକ୍ସ। ଡୋମିନୋ ଇଫେକ୍ଟ କ'ଣ ନା, କେତେବେଳେ ଡୋମିନୋ ଇଫେକ୍ଟ ଇଜ୍ ଦି ଫିଫ୍ଥ ପ୍ରି କଣ୍ଡିସନ ଅଫ୍ ଏଥନିକ କନଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ। ସେଇଟା କ'ଣ ନା, ଇଫ୍ ୟର ସରାଉଣ୍ଡିଂ କଣ୍ଟ୍ରି ଅର୍ ସରାଉଣ୍ଡିଂ ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ ଅର୍ ସରାଉଣ୍ଡିଂ ଡିଷ୍ଟ୍ରିକ୍ଟ, ଦ୍ୟାର୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏ କାଇଣ୍ଡ ଅଫ୍ ଏଥନିକ ପଲିଟିକ୍ସ, ଦେନ୍ ଇଟ୍ ଗିଭ୍ସ ଏ ୱେ ଫର୍ ଏଥନିକ କନଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ, ଇଟ୍ ଗିଭ୍ସ ଏ ୱେ ଫର୍ ଏଥନିକ କନଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ। ଯେମିତି ଏଥନିକ ପଲିଟିକ୍ସ ଇନ୍ ଶ୍ରୀଲଙ୍କା, ଇଟ୍ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ହ୍ୟାଭ୍ ଇଫେକ୍ଟ ଅନ୍ ଇଣ୍ଡିଆ ଆଣ୍ଡ ପାକିସ୍ତାନ। ତେଣୁ ବିଭିନ୍ନ ଦେଶରେ, ବିଭିନ୍ନ ରାଜ୍ୟରେ ଯଦି ଏଥନିକ ପଲିଟିକ୍ସ ଚାଲୁଥାଏ, ସେଇଟା ବି ଗୋଟେ ଇନୋ କଣ୍ଡିସନ କ୍ରିଏଟ୍ କରାଏ, ତାଦ୍ୱାରା ଇନୋ ଗୋଟେ ଏଥନିକ କନଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ ଏଟା ଘଟିଥାଏ, ମାନେ ଏଥନିକ କନଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ ହ୍ୟାପେନ୍ସ ଡ୍ୟୁ ଟୁ ଦି ଡୋମିନୋ ଇଫେକ୍ଟ। ଦେନ୍ ଦି ଦି ରୋଲ୍ ଅଫ୍ ହିଷ୍ଟ୍ରି, ସୋ ପିପୁଲ ଡିରାଇଭ୍ସ କନଫିଡେନ୍ସ, ସାଇକୋଲୋଜିକାଲ ୟୁ ନୋ ସାଇକୋଲୋଜିକାଲ ସେନ୍ସ ଫ୍ରମ୍ ଦି ହିଷ୍ଟ୍ରି। ଯଦି ଆମର ଦେଶଟା ଗୋଟେ ଟିପିକାଲ ଏଥନିକ ହିଷ୍ଟ୍ରିକୁ ରିପ୍ରେଜେଣ୍ଟ କରୁଥାଏ, ତେବେ ବି ଆମ ଭିତରେ ଗୋଟେ ୟୁନୋ ଏଥନିକ ସେନ୍ସ ପଳେଇ ଆସେ। ଯେମିତିକି ଆମର ଯେଉଁ ଆମର ହିଷ୍ଟ୍ରିକୁ ଦେଖିବା ପାଇଁ ଗଲେ, ଆମର ଯେଉଁ ପାର୍ଟିସନଟା ହେଲା, ପାର୍ଟିସନ ଇଜ୍ ଏ ହିଷ୍ଟ୍ରି ଟୁ ଆସ୍। ପାର୍ଟିସନଟାରେ ଯେଉଁ ହିନ୍ଦୁ ମୁସଲିମ ଗୋଟେ ରିଲିଜିଅନ ଆଧାରରେ ଯେଉଁ ଆମର ଗୋଟେ ପାର୍ଟିସନ ହେଲା, ସେ ପାର୍ଟିସନର ଗୋଟେ ଇମ୍ପାକ୍ଟ, ସେ ହିଷ୍ଟ୍ରିର ଗୋଟେ ଇମ୍ପାକ୍ଟ ଆଜି ବି ଆମ ମାଇଣ୍ଡ ଭିତରେ ଅଛି। ସେ ମାଇଣ୍ଡ କ'ଣ ନା, ଆମେ ମୁସଲମାନ ମାନଙ୍କୁ ପାକିସ୍ତାନ ସହିତ ଆଇଡେଣ୍ଟିଫାଏ କରୁଛୁ, ଆମେ ତାଙ୍କୁ ହିନ୍ଦୁ ସହିତ ଆଇଡେଣ୍ଟିଫାଏ କରିପାରୁ ନାହୁଁ। ତେଣୁ ଆମେ ଇଣ୍ଡିଆନ ମୁସଲିମ ମାନଙ୍କୁ କହୁଛି, ଇଫ୍ ୟୁ ଆର୍ ନଟ୍ ୱିଥ୍ ଆସ୍ ଦେନ୍ ୟୁ ଗୋ ଟୁ ଦି ପାକିସ୍ତାନ। ଏଟା କାହିଁକି ହେଉଛି ନା, ଦେର୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏ ହିଷ୍ଟୋରିକାଲ ଇନ୍ଫ୍ଲୁଏନ୍ସ ଓଭର ଆସ୍। ସୋ ଦିଜ୍ ଆର୍ ଦି ପ୍ରି କଣ୍ଡିସନ୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଏଥନିକ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟ। ନାଓ ହାଉ ଦି ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ ୟୁନୋ ରେସ୍ପଣ୍ଡ to this ethnic conflict. Now, the mode of there are three mode of response from the state to the ethnic conflict. First is the assimilative, second is the accommodative, and third is the separation. Assimilation ta kana, now if you remember just recently, amar jo article 370 ta ko hatai diya gala, hatai ki union territories karagala, aw union territories ko you know sapo moriboni badi bhangiboni, gote non political sense re politics play karagala, mu aku emti kahuchi non political sense re politics play karagala, aw Jammu Kashmir ko India sahita jodi diya gala. तो सेठी आमे कौन देखिलु ना गोटे प्रकार रो एसिमिलेशन देखिलु आ एसिमिलेशन केमती हला ना सेठी आमे आर्मी पठेलु पुलिस पठेलु सेठी आमे कोर्जन अप्लाई करलु राइट फोर्स पठेलु तनो एसिमिलेशन थ्रू रे एथनिक कॉन्फ्लिक्ट को स्टेट रिस्पोंस करि परिबो आ गोटे कोन ना अकोमोडेशन ना सही आर्टिकल 370 कथा नबा ना जतबेले इनो जम्मू कश्मीर भारत सहित जोड़ीबा पई चाहू नथला हरि सिंह चाहू थला इंडिपेंडेंट नेशन ले ताकू रखेबा पई तो सतबेले नेहरू कोन कले ना नेहरू आर्टिकल 370 तांको गिफ्ट रे देले तांको स्पेशल स्टेटस बनेबा पई कहले आ कहले कि यू आर द इंटीग्रल पार्ट ऑफ द इंडिया तेनो समटाइम्स यू नो एथनिक कॉन्फ्लिक्ट को डील करबा पई गोटे प्रकार अकोमोडेशन करा जाय से अकोमोडेशन ता होची कोन ना अटैचमेंट ऑफ आर्टिकल 370 टू जम्मू कश्मीर सहित ताको अटैच करा गेला ता पर ता द्वारा कोन हैला ना जम्मू कश्मीर लोक दे दे गोटे प्रकार आकु गोटे प्रकार एपीजमेंट कहबे आई विल टेल इट एज ए एपीजमेंट जो अकोमोडेट करा गेला काश्मीर जम्मू काश्मीर भारत गोटे अंग हो पारि न था तेणु अंग करवाई तो यही प्रकार गोटे डिसीजन जवाहरलाल नेहरू नहीं दैट इज अकोमोडेशन देन दि सेपरेशन सेपरेशन कौन ना इफ यू रिमेम्बर दि बार्थ ऑफ पाकिस्तान सेपरेशन कौन इफ यू रिमेम्बर दि बार्थ ऑफ बांग्लादेश कि समटाइम्स एथनिक कॉन्फ्लिक्ट को दूर करिया पई जदी आज आज ठीक मन रख आज जदी इंडिया पाकिस्तान एका सतर थांते आमो भितरे बहुत रायट हेई थांत आमरो एक्जिस्टेंस को आमे निजे ही नष्ट कर दे थां बहुत वायलेंस हेई थांत आमो भितरे काहे कि ना आमो भितरे दुईटा साइकोलॉजी तयारी हेई सारी थिला ब्रिटिशर मानकर जो यू नो टू नेशन थ्योरी से जिनसटा आमो भितरे गुटे डीपर इंपैक्ट पकेई सारी थिला तेणु से एथनिक कॉन्फ्लिक्ट जो गोटे एथनिक गोटे वातावरण सृष्टि एथनिक मूवमेंट एथनिक कॉन्फ्लिक्ट मानते गोटे भयाभय वातावरण जो सृष्टि जो डर लगुला कि पोले मुसलमान आसिक हिंदू को मारिदे पोले हिंदू जा मुसलमान को मारी दूसरे बहुत सारा बॉलीवुड मूवी भी गेट दैट सेन्स तो से स्टेट कौन कला स्टेट कौन कला पूरा तेणु ये जो सेपरेशन एज ए मोड ऑफ स्टेट रेस्पॉन्स टू एथनिसिटी और एथनिक कॉन्फ्लिक्ट प्राइमरी द प्राइम एग्जांपल इज द बर्थ ऑफ पाकिस्तान इट इज द बर्थ ऑफ बांग्लादेश व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ एथनिक मूवमेंट इन इंडिया यू मे फाइंड देयर आर फोर मेनली मोस्टली फोर काइंड्स ऑफ एथनिक यू नो मूवमेंट फोर काइंड्स ऑफ और फोर फॉर्म्स ऑफ एथनिक मूवमेंट कौन पॉलिटिकल एथनिक मूवमेंट से कौन ना इफ यू यू नो गो टू दि काश्मीर राइट जम्मू काश्मीर एंड ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड दे आर प्रॉब्लम देन यू विल फाइंड दैट यू विल गेट अ सेंस दैट दिस एथनिक कॉन्फ्लिक्ट ऑफ जम्मू काश्मीर रिप्रेजेंट्स to political right this is purely political this is politics then there is a linguistic mode of ethnic movement what is a linguistic mode of ethnic movement now if you you know go back to this Tamil Nadu you know, Dravidian movement, then you will find that it began as a movement based on language. So on the basis of language also, you know, my language is my identity. On the basis of language also, there is ethnic movement. Then on the basis of religion, as I said, if you you know, understand the emergence of Pakistan and the history relating to the partition, then you can understand the religion mode of you know, ethnic movement. Then there is a tribal mode of ethnic movement. What is a tribal mode of ethnic movement? If you understand the northeast problem. So northeast wala kon kahuchanti northeast problem ta kon na semane gote autonomy demand korchanti odisha sorry autonomy demand korchanti indian our territory with your Indian state forcibly tame tumar territory ko amo territory ko neki tame Indian state re tume taku misai deicha. But sathi dita badhiya interesting jinsa achi ki how to understand the northeast ethnic movement. So there are mainly two perspective to understand this northeast ethnic movement, and the two perspective is that nation state building perspective aguta hocho federation building perspective. ए जो नेशन स्टेट बिल्डिंग प्रस्पेक्टिव अछि इट इज प्राइमरीली द प्रस्पेक्टिव ऑफ स्टेट आ जोंटा फेडरेशन बिल्डिंग प्रस्पेक्टिव अछि सेटा होछि द प्रस्पेक्टिव ऑफ नॉर्थ ईस्ट बा नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न प्रस्पेक्टिव आ स्टेट प्रस्पेक्टिव बा नेशन स्टेट बिल्डिंग प्रस्पेक्टिव कोन कहउछि ना से कहउछि द प्रोसेस ऑफ नेशन बिल्डिंग इन द फेस ऑफ द कॉन्फ्लिक्ट बिटवीन द मॉडर्न एंड ट्रेडिशन से कहउछि जे नॉर्थ ईस्ट रे जो एथनिक कॉन्फ्लिक्ट चली से एथनिक कॉन्फ्लिक्ट दिस इज बिकॉज दिस इज द रिजल्ट ऑफ द यू नो नेवर एंडिंग कंटिन्यूअस कॉन्फ्लिक्ट बिटवीन द मॉडर्निटी एंड द ट्रेडिशन. मॉडर्निटी कौन ना मॉडर्निटी रिप्रेजेंट्स डेवलपमेंट मॉडर्निटी रिप्रेजेंट्स डेमोक्रेटिक इंस्टीट्यूशन आउ ट्रेडिशन रिप्रेजेंट्स कौन ना एक्जिस्टेंस ऑफ आवर कल्चर existence of our you know diversity, right? To semane kouchanti jehetu modern out tradition bhitre gote prakar ro conflict chaluchi se conflict ta never ending conflict sethi pai northeast re jo ethnic movement chalchi seta aji porjan chalichi ki indian state se nije you know tradition ku accommodate kari paruni ki northeast mane semane ei modern institution industry taku accept kari paru naanti. That is one part. The other thing is that the northeastern perspective jonda ame kouche federation building perspective se kon kouchi na the problem of northeast is the result of nation state building se kouchi tume nation state jonga gote impose korcho tuma nation state ama upare that is the main problem. Right? And semane kon argue korchanti na the national leader in the quest of nation building project, the dominant groups of the country represented by the central government and mainstream leadership ignore the periphery and smaller tamane se kon kouchanti na jo tame ama upare nation building jo project ta impose korucho seita houchi north mane seita houchi tumara north indian you know nationality ko ama upare impose korucho तुमर जो कोर नेशनलिज्म होचे सेटा हम ऊपर इंपोज करता हम को कहू जे इंडियन होबा पई आमे तुम भलिया चिंता करिबू तुम भलिया कहिबू किंतु आमो भितरे जो गोटे प्रकार रो ए सेंस ऑफ पेरिफेरीनेस अछि आमो भितरे जो प्रकार रो गोटे यूनिकनेस अछि आमो भितरे जो गोटे प्रकार रो गोटे स्मॉलर नेशनलिटीज अछि तमे तेटा को इग्नोर करूचो. यू आर पेइंग लेस अटेंशन टू द ह्यूमन राइट वायलेशन इन द नॉर्थ ईस्ट तुम्हें ह्यूमन राइट वायलेशन कथा तो कहुच किंतु तुम्हें आम इलाका रे जो ह्यूमन राइट वायलेशन होची जो अंडर न्यूट्रिशन होची पोवर्टी अछि तुम्हें ए सब जिंस को एड्रेस करुन तुम्हें केवल आमको इंडियन करेबा पछरे लागिछ किंतु आम सुख दुख रो तुम्हें भागीदारी हेउ ना हो. right? And these factors have resulted in the insurgency problem in the Northeast. Ta mane mate khali kahucho mu tumaro puo kintu mo pai jeti ki kartavya achi seti ki tume karuno sethi pai mu tomo tharu alga haba pai chaunchi eti mu mane kon na Northeast state puo mane kon its relation with it's a relation puo is a relationship eti bapo kie na Indian state. The Indian state is saying that Northeast is my part, but it is not giving importance to the Northeast. And this perspective is well articulated the suggestion. Ye jo achi amaro federation building perspective, ye gute suggestion douchi. Se suggestion kon na the country should replace their nation state building approach in favor of genuine federation building approach. Se kahuchi kon, if you want me or want the Northeast state to be the genuine part of Indian state, then you should stop your nation building approach rather than you should concentrate on federation building approach, right? So these are the different kinds of ethnic movement in India. Now how this ethnicity is related with the nationalism, right? Or nation state. So as I said earlier, every ethnic group subsequently it becomes a ethnic community. Ketabale na jetabale it satisfy certain precondition. What I said earlier, if ethnic group satisfied some of the precondition, then it becomes a ethnic community. And when that ethnic community started social movement and becomes politically so active, then it creates certain kind of nationalism that is called ethnic nationalism. That means jodi mane aji you know gude example ta naba aguru jon ko dalit kaila bel ko taku bahut kharap lagutila कहीं से गोटे हेल्पलेस कम्युनिटी आकार किंतु एबे जने प्राउडली निजु कही पारुचे कि मु दलित एटा काहीके हे पारुचे कारण देयर इज ए काइंड ऑफ मूवमेंट दलित एजिटेशन दलित मूवमेंट दलित हैज अचीव्ड ए काइंड ऑफ आइडेंटिटी एंड दिस आइडेंटिटी इज बीइंग काउंटेड इन पॉलिटिक्स यू कैन not defy the Dalit identity. With that Dalit identity, it is because of their agitation, their organization and their education. Right now a Dalit do not feel bad to call himself as a Dalit. So county na county, there is a kind of a nationalism within that Dalit movement, within their Dalit discourse, right? So they belong to that kind of nationalism. A Dalit belongs to that Dalit nationalism. So as a Dalit, I don't feel bad because I have made my presence strong in the theory and practice, right? So there is a sociologist called Anthony D. Smith. He has given four conditions on which ethnicity transform into nationalism. Tano hotat gude ethnic nationalism create heuni. Ethnic nationalism tara bibhinna stara achi. Prathame ethnic group, tapare ethnic community, tapare hobo ethnic nationalism. So Anthony D. Smith, he has given four conditions on which ethnicity transform into nationalism. Na kono na ethnic group must be transferred into ethnic community. Prathame ethnic group ta ethnic community hoba darkar. Kete bale ethnic group ta ethnic community hoba na jete bale se consciousness ta paibo. When the ethnic group will get the consciousness that they are one, they belonging to one, their problem is one, their aspiration is one, their exploitation is one, then that ethnic group becomes a ethnic community. Then the second condition, similar movement around the globe. Jonda purbaru mu kahili jodi similar kind of movement jodi Sri Lanka ro gote ethnic movement chaluchi, then India आउ पाकिस्तान ले लोको एथनिक मूवमेंट करिबा पई गोटे स्पृहा पाइबे तेणु दैट इज द सेकंड कंडीशन ऑफ एथनिसिटी ट्रांसफॉर्मिंग इनटू नेशनलिज्म से माने गोटे ब्रोडो गोटे ब्रोड डिस्कोर्स रे से माने पार्ट हेबे राइट देन देयर मस्ट बी ए स्ट्रैटम ऑफ इंटेलेक्चुअल तमाने विदाउट इंटेलेक्चुअल that your ethnicity cannot become ethnic nationalism. And ethnic community, in order to become or in order to gain the feature of ethnic colors attached to you, then such conditions fulfill in the history through war, revolution, and migration. Right? So there are, history, there are war, there are revolution, there are migration. That also plays a very greater role in order to convert a ethnic community into ethnic nationalism, right? So there are mainly three theorists of ethnicity and nationalism. And who are the theorists? Now, Bendit Anderson, then Ernest Gellner, then Eric Hobsbawm. Let us come to the Anderson and his contribution. If you remember the name Anderson, then you perhaps can remember his concept of imagined community. And why imagined? Now, imagined because even without knowing each other, an image of communion, that means I may not know you, but I belong to you. I may not know you. The Dalit of the Odia Dalit, they don't know the Telangana Dalit, but I can see my image in you. It happens in the imagination. Mo cognitive level le janini, kintu mo affective level le a Odia Dalit knows a Telangana Dalit, a Odia Dalit knows a Mahara Dalit or Maharashtra Dalit, right? No nation imagine itself with whole mankind, unlike Christianity and Islam. Ta mane kono ki every community is very much limited, right? So no community represents the whole mankind except Christianity and Islam. So Christianity as a religious, as a organized religion, Islam as a organized religion, it believes in proselytization because they think that entire world, all the individuals, they are actually Christian, but they do not know that they are Christian. So it is our job to make them into Christian. Civilizing mission, jonta ame kahuchu. Right? Kintu ethnicity, ba ethnic community, they don't imagine that they represent the whole mankind, certain basis on which their community stands. Then they aspire for sovereignty. Every ethnic community, they need sovereignty. Sovereignty means internally and externally free. That means no interference. State amo kothare interfere kori paribo nahi. We have our culture have its own right to culture. Ame jonta kahuchu amar se interfere kari paribo nahi. And what made new communities imaginable is interaction between capitalism, technology, and diversity. So all this capitalism, technology, and diversity that tries to make ethnic community. And it converts that ethnic community into ethnic nationalism. So jetebale capitalism samna ko palai aschi, jetebale technology samna ko palai aschi, right? If I remember amar jetebale Hyderabad ro online admission hela, setebale amar ATM amar jo university ATM eta thila ATM counter sethi lekha aitila this online system is Brahminical. Mane use of technology, it is the manifestation of Brahminical culture. Tamane technology Babaji is anti Dalit, right? So when there is technology, when there is capitalism, when there is a logic of diversity, then all these ethnic community, they assert their identity and they try to become they try to inherit a kind of ethnic nationalism within their psychology. And after getting that psychology, they try to pursue it before the state, right? So that is Anderson and his imagined community. Then Ernest Gellner, to him, nationalism is a product of a kind of industrial society. So nationalism, to him, nationalism is based on modern division of labor, and it requires a constant mobility and migration break apart from the traditional order. There is a search for new ties where culture must be contemporaneous with the state, and nationalism fit here. And universal standardized education geared to achieve this nationalist goal. तेणु आर्नेस्ट गेलर तांक मत कौन ना सी कहते कि आम इंडस्ट्रियल सोसाइटी आसी सारापर आम भितर नेशनलिज्म डेवलप कर नेशनलिज्म ना गोटे प्रकार सिविक नेशनलिज्म डेवलप कर गोटे प्रकार एथनिक नेशनलिज्म डेवलप कर सिविक नेशनलिज्म रो बेस कौन ना सिविक नेशनलिज्म रो बेस हूँ इट आइडेंटिफाइड विथ दि सिटीजनशिप एंड इन इट्स प्रिंसिपल इट इज ओपन एंड इट कैन बी एक्वायर्ड दैट इज ए सिविक नेशनलिज्म माने इंडस्ट्रियल सोसाइटी केवल सिविक नेशनलिज्म को क्रिएट करनी एटा गोटे एथनिक नेशनलिज्म को भी क्रिएट करी कौन ना इट इज इनहेरेंट त माने ए नेशनलिज्म समथिंग व्हिच इज इनहेरेंट टू दैट कम्युनिटी टू दैट आइडेंटिटी इट कैन नॉट बी एक्वायर्ड इट इज बेस्ड और इट इज ए एस्क्रिप्टिव वैल्यू इट इज ए एस्क्रिप्टिव वैल्यू यू कैन नॉट एक्वायर इट ओनली व्हेन यू आर बोर्न देन यू आर पार्ट ऑफ दैट When you are psychologically connected to it, then only you are part of it. It is not open; it is very much closed, right? This industrial society has created two kinds of nationalism. One is migration. जितना migration हो ची ସେତେବେଳେ ସପୋଜ ଯେଉଁ ଓଡ଼ିଆଟେ ଯାଉଛି ସୁରଟରେ କାମ କରିବା ପାଇଁ ସେପଟେ ତ ଖାଲି ଓଡ଼ିଆ ଯାଉନାହାନ୍ତି ବିଭିନ୍ନ ରାଜ୍ୟରୁ ଲୋକ ଯାଉଛନ୍ତି ତ ସେଠି ସେମାନେ ପରସ୍ପରକୁ କେମିତି ଆଇଡେଣ୍ଟିଫାଏ କରୁଛନ୍ତି ସେଠି ସେମାନେ ଭାବୁଛନ୍ତି ସିନ୍ସ ଆମେ ଯେହେତୁ ବିଦେଶରେ ଅଛୁ ତେଣୁ ଆମେ ସମସ୍ତେ ଭାରତୀୟ ଯେମିତିକି ହାଇଦ୍ରାବାଦ ଯେତେବେଳେ ଆମେ ଓଡ଼ିଶା ଭିତରେ ବି ବହୁତ ପ୍ରକାରର ଡାଇଭରସିଟି ଅଛି କିନ୍ତୁ ଯେତେବେଳେ ଆମେ ହାଇଦ୍ରାବାଦ ୟୁନିଭର୍ସିଟି ଯାଉଛୁ ସେତେବେଳେ ଆମେ କହୁଛୁ ଆମେ ଓଡ଼ିଆ ଆମେ ଏକ ଆମର ଗୋଟେ ଆଇଡେଣ୍ଟିଟି ଯେତେବେଳେ ଆମେ ୟୁନୋ ଆମେ ଯେତେବେଳେ ଭାରତର ବାହାରକୁ ଯାଉଛୁ ସେତେବେଳେ ଆମର କେବଳ ଗୋଟେ ଆଇଡେଣ୍ଟିଟି ହେଉଛି ଦେଟ୍ ୱି ଆର୍ ଅଲ୍ ଇଣ୍ଡିଆନ୍ ତେଣୁ ମାଇଗ୍ରେସନ୍ ଆମ ଭିତରେ ଗୋଟେ ପ୍ରକାର ନ୍ୟାସନାଲିଜିମ୍କୁ କ୍ରିଏଟ୍ କରାଉଛି ରାଇଟ୍ ଯେତେବେଳେ ଆମେ ଓଡ଼ିଶାରେ ରହୁଛେ ଆମେ ଏଥନିକ୍ ନ୍ୟାସନାଲିଜିମ୍ ଦ୍ୱାରା ଗାଇଡେଡ଼୍ ହେଉଛେ ଆମେ ଆମର କମ୍ୟୁନିଟିର ଆଇଡେଣ୍ଟିଟି ଦ୍ୱାରା ଗାଇଡେଡ଼୍ ହେଉଛେ ଯେତେବେଳେ ଆମେ ଟିକେ ବାହାରକୁ ଯାଉଛେ ରାଇଟ୍ ସେତେବେଳେ ଆମେ କ'ଣ କରୁଛେ ନା ସିଭିକ୍ ନ୍ୟାସନାଲିଟି ଦ୍ୱାରା ଆମେ ଗାଇଡେଡ଼୍ ହେଉଛେ ରାଇଟ୍ ଦେନ୍ ଦି ଲାଷ୍ଟ ଥିଓରିଷ୍ଟ ଅଫ୍ ଏଥନିସିଟି ଆଣ୍ଡ ନ୍ୟାସନାଲିଜିମ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦି ଏରିକ୍ ହବ୍ସମ୍ ଟୁ ଏରିକ୍ ହବ୍ସମ୍ ଏଜ୍ ଏନ୍ ଇନ୍ଭେନ୍ସନ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ନେସନ୍ ଏଜ୍ ଏନ୍ ଇନ୍ଭେନ୍ସ ଇଞ୍ଜିନିୟରିଂ ସୋ ଦେର୍ ଆର୍ ସର୍ଟେନ୍ Nation is inherent political destiny. Nation is natural and inherent political destiny. Reality kana na nation is a artifact. Nation is an invention. Nation is a social engineering. Tane myth kana kahuchi na myth hauchi if you remember the primordial theory of ethnicity. That is the myth. Tano Hubbard jo amar achi Hobson Eric Hobson he rejects the primordial theory of ethnicity. He says that primordial mode of ethnicity it is a myth. And what is the reality? Now the reality that he accept the modernization theory and constructivism theory of ethnicity. To Eric Hobson, the reality is that ethnicity or nationality, nationalism, eta mane eta nahi mane exist karuni ଆକୁ ଆମେ ବନଉଛୁ, ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଆର୍ଟିଫାକ୍ଟ, ଆକୁ ଆମେ ଇନଭେଣ୍ଟ କରୁଛୁ, ଆକୁ ଆମେ ତିଆରି କରୁଛୁ। ଏ କଲଚରାଲ ନ୍ୟାସନାଲିଜିମ୍ ଯୋଉ ବିଜେପି କହୁଛି, ଏଇଟା କ'ଣ ଆଗରୁ ଅଛି? ଏରିକ୍ ହବସମ୍ କହୁଛନ୍ତି ନା, ଏଇଟାକୁ ବିଜେପି ତିଆରି କରୁଛି, ଏଟାକୁ ଇଟ୍ସ ଏ mad very much on a culture and merely invented and constructed from the above to be analyzed from the below। तेणु एरिक हब्सन कहते कि जो नेशन टा आम याल से नेशन टा कौठ ताब तलु या से नेशन टा ताब ऊपर ताब किंतु जोटा या दैट मस्ट बी एक्जामिन दैट मस्ट बी एनालाइज फ्रम दि बिलो एंड चेंज एंड सिफ्ट इन नेशन देर इज चेंज इन सिफ्ट इन नेशन नेशन इज नॉट परमानेंट the understanding of nationality nationalism nation ethnicity this is not permanent this is subjected to change there is a shift in the meaning of nation and nationalism so in the conclusion let me bring Robert Dahl that that ethnic nationalism or in other words jo namar ko course rathi ethnicity and nation state it is something unavoidable in Indian democracy right so you have to accommodate the ethnic aspiration and to accommodate it is much more a difficult task it is much more a difficult task for the liberal democracy because electoral politics in democracy it always turns into be ethnic right electoral politics in a democracy turns to be ethnic and ethnic minority in a majoritarian democratic setup ethnic minority always feels underrepresented they always feels alienated right so hence this ethnic conflict is a democratic dilemma for Indian state ethnic conflict is a democratic dilemma dilemma means something we know jemte ki corona gote dilemma tamane ame janichu corona houchi kintu corona pai samadhan nai ame jo pote gale ame corona dwara akrant hei jauchu moruchu nischita ame ghare luchile bi no khai ki moruchu gharu bahar कोरोना पाई भी आमे मरुछु तनो कोरोना हैज क्रिएटेड सर्टेन काइंड ऑफ डिलेमा इन आवर माइंड सो फार एज आवर लाइफ इज कंसर्न सो दिस एथनिक दे क्रिएट्स ए डेमोक्रेटिक डिलेमा फॉर इंडियन स्टेट एंड दिस एथनिक सेल्फ डिटरमिनेशन इज आल्सो नॉट द सॉल्यूशन त माने सिंपली जदी स्टेट जदी इन एपिज कला जो आम कहे स्टेट रेस्पन्स एथनिक कनफ्लिक्ट प्रति कौन अच्छी ना स्टेट सदा बेले फोर्स यूज करेट तो निज लोक समय धरिकी फोर्स यूज कर स्टेट सदा बेले यूनो एपिज भी करकोमोडेट सदा बेले कारण तुम जब जन को एपिज कर तो डिमांड करुच्ची तुम तो केवल जन को दबनी रसगुल्ला आउ जन भी से रसगुल्ला खावाई चाहिए तुम पाखे रसगुल्ला ना देर इज ए स्कर्सिटी अफ रिसोर्सेस एंड स्टेट सदा बेले सेपरेट कर जमी से पाकिस्तान को सेपरेट करदेला एटी तेलेाना को गोटे सेपरेट करदेला का तेलेाना भितर आउ गोटे ग्रुप टे भारी पड़े तुम्हें इन सेपरेट केत टू व्हाट एक्सटेंट एंड इन द लास्ट एवरी इंडिविजुअल विल बिकम ए काइंड ऑफ एम्बॉडीमेंट ऑफ एथनिसिटी दैट आई एम वन काइंड ऑफ एथनिसिटी अंतर्जामी इज अनदर काइंड ऑफ एथनिसिटी टू what extent we can apply this separation to the state so hence this ethnic self determination is also not the solution to the problem so thank you very much
okay thank you so much Dr. Himanshu Sagar Mishra sir let's have some water sir
It's near about 1.5 hours,
Nandini. Yes, sir, it's a long class, And it's really energetic and really articulated, well-articulated class. Like you touch upon, you start from how different ethnicity and nation states. Then you touch upon the theoretical part, the primordial approach, the primordial theory, and modern approach, then Marxist approach, then constructive approach. So this is the way we develop the idea of ethnicity and the nation state in the broader sense. And I hope the students will get benefit of all the idea and all the concept or the whole the theoretical aspect of ethnicity. Then you also touch upon the conflict part, how the ethnicity is a bigger instrument, the different section of the society or different section in all over India are fighting for their own superiority. Like you mentioned about the vertical conflict and horizontal conflict, so well articulated and so well discussed in this class. Then you touch upon most of the part of ethnicity and nation states, and you finally conclude your argument and conclude your class with the like renowned political theorist like Robert Dahl, who talk about how ethnicity or nation state is playing an important role in the contemporary situation. So having said this word, I want to take, we will take four or five questions maybe. That would be good for you. So let's. I'm like saying five yes. or six most important questions in this session. So
yes.
Okay. So the first question is asking by Kavita Bohidar. She's asking about how religion related to ethnicity and nation state. How religion is how it's related with ethnicity and nation states. And can you add this another question? The same students, like ethnicity, how the ethnicity impact on the or effect on the politics? Please add this on one question. Okay.
Yes.
So second question is, what is the relevance of ethnicity in the world of multiculturalism? What is the relevance of ethnicity in the world of multiculturalism?
What is the relevance of ethnicity in the world of multiculturalism? Yes. Yes.
The third question is, what are the dangers of ethnic nationalism?
Yes.
Okay, sir. The fourth question is, he's asking about when you were saying the cultural nationalism is a Hindu culture and the BJP invented idea, could you mention? So basically he's asking about how the he's basically asking how the BJP imposing the cultural nationalism in India, particularly on the name of ethnicity, on the name of Hindu as an ethnic group, basically he's
how BJP generate
new idea or develop a Hindu idea and imposing as a cultural nationalism.
Cultural nationalism.
So this is fourth question, right? The last question will take. Hello, sir.
Yes.
The last question will take. Why religion is an important role in Indian political system, and how do you see that? How religion play an important role in Indian political system or Indian politics, and how do you see that in the context of Indian constitution?
How is it?
Hello, sir.
How religion plays an important role
in Indian politics?
The last question, how religion plays an important role in Indian politics?
He basically asking in the context of Indian constitution. Right, sir. Okay, please take it.
Right. So the first question is that how religion related to ethnicity and nation state, how ethnicity impact the politics. I think if you just try to understand the emergence of Pakistan and the role of religion as a mode of ethnicity and how it played a greater role creating a Islamic state of Pakistan, there you can understand, right? So it's not a, it's a very, I will say that it's a long question, right? So in not and sell, I will say that you please watch the movie of Partition. Then you can understand how religion related to ethnicity and nation state, how the Islamic State Pakistan, it was created, and how ethnicity impact politics. See, our politics today is identity politics, and every identity is based on certain kind of ethnicity, right? So, kemiti seta heitan na prathame ethnic group ta bhitre consciousness asila, si ethnic community hela, ethnic community hela pare dhire dhire si taro nijaro nationalism ko develop kala, jonta ethnic nationalism ko develop kala, si develop kari sala pare, then it creates a political party on that ethnicity and tries to play politics in a larger framework. And when a ethnic community plays politics, then that politics is known as the identity politics. So politics kotha kahuchu, identity politics kotha kahuchu. Even the majority, Hindu is also an ethnic category. Hindu is also playing a kind, or the identity is always related with the politics. Again, it is also another long question, right? If I'll write, then I can bring many important points that how ethnicity, is having a impact over the politics, how politics is impacting ethnicity, and how ethnicity is impacting to politics. Ethi ethnicity jata bale kahuchi answer kemti korajibo ethnicity ko ame nei jiba caste nei jiba religion nei jiba ame culture nei jiba civilization nei jiba language nei jiba ta ame dekhiba language politics ko kemti affect korchi politics language ko kemti affect korchi caste politics ko kemti affect korchi politics caste ko kemti affect korchi right. So if you will go on, then you may discover certain things. Then hopefully you will be able to answer ki this is how ethnicity have a impact over the politics, and politics is also having impact over the ethnicity, right? Then the second question. The world of multiculturalism revolves around the concept of diversity, maintaining the diversity. Now, diversity or demand local by marginalized community by ethnic community kete bale karibe na jete bale tanko bhitre gote prakar ro ethnic nationalism tiyari hobo tenu ethnicity re kon hochi na there is a transform from ethnic group to ethnic nationalism. Then ethnicity is actually providing the base or platform on which diversity diversity is coming very clearly, and multiculturalism argues to maintain that diversity, that you cannot follow the policy of assimilation, you cannot follow the policy of what is the discrimination. Right, so both the policies, whether assimilation or discrimination, both are against the diversity. So ethnicity gives the platform to the multicultural that we know what exactly we are. We want to protect our own culture and please, ethnicity or multiculturalism bitre tar connecting point out diversity. Ethnicity diversity create karauchi, multiculturalism se diversity ko maintain karauchi. Kahi ki na ye dite jako democracy soito related. Karena democracy, democracy should not believe in assimilation. Democracy should not be based on discrimination. Right? Karena democracy assimilation ko bhi follow kariboni, ki democracy discrimination ko bhi base kariboni. Right? Then the third question, what is the danger of ethnic nationalism? The danger of ethnic nationalism that it is based on ascriptive value. Jemti ki ame caste katha kahuche. Jemti tume caste as a ethnic group, Brahmin as a ethnic group, you cannot enter to Brahmin as a ethnic group. You cannot enter to Dalit as a ethnic group. So my question, my hard hit question is that how many Brahmins are part of the Dalit movement? To what extent the Dalit movement has incorporated non-Dalit in its folder? Why it is happening? Because all these I'm taking Dalit movement as an example. So all these ethnic movement or ethnic conflict, there is a kind of ethnic nationalism, and that ethnic nationalism is based on ascriptive value. It is not based on acquired value. Right? It is ascriptive. Tamane it is closed. That is the danger of ethnic nationalism. Open helesina danger no, close hegal to danger na. Then the fourth, how BJP invented the idea of cultural nationalism. BJP jetebale amaro jodi tumhe dekhibo aryan aur dravidian jetebale sob asile to aryan mane bahut spread kari gale, right? E aryan man ko pakuru hi caste srushti hela, right? E jo caste formation hela to se mane aryan mane brahmana khetriya boisya sudre hele puni aryan mane asisala pare kon kale na sabu dravidian mane sabu north re hi thile se north ru pura south ward ku palai gale to south ward ku gala pare Aryan mane north Dravidian man ko satre jetale interaction kale satabale jo mane tike higher mane jo mane landlord to semane kon kale na to tanku semane dalit banai dele tano kon tina kon ti Dravidian mane encultured heigale Aryan culture tano ame dekhilu India tale ame dekhilu hindu man ko bhitre diversity achi. But mostly I'm thinking Hindu mane 80% hai gale. Dravidian man to Hindu nathile. Tanku Hindu kora gala. Large number of Dravidian has been converted into Hinduism. So jete bale amaro mane gote prakar Hindu man kor sankhya jete bale badhi gala. To sete bale BJP pai eta subidha hai gala. BJP dekhila kono na mu jodi Hindu ro interest Hindura voice ko jodi mu represent karibi au tebe mu dinen dine national politics ko mu represent karibi au dinen dine mu desha ko rule bi karibi 2014 pakuru ame seita dekhuchu ta purbaru BJP dhire dhire emerge bi karithibar ame dekhichu au jo cultural nationalism asila na oi cultural nationalism kona na India is Hindustan. And those who are non-Hindu, they have to accept that their ancestors are Hindu. To some extent, it is right. But to claim it sounds very odd to so far as Indian secularism is concerned. It sounds very odd. Maybe their ancestors are Hindu. Tamane kon hochi census re kon hochi? Tame Christian? Na. Tame Muslim? Na. Tame Buddhist na, tame Sikh na, tal tame Hindu. Tano ei jo prakar ro gote tendency ame jo follow karuchu, save to gote prakar ro cultural nationalism create hochi. Tamane kon if you are not in their fold, then you are Hindu. तेणु इन दैट सेन्स ऑल ट्राइबल्स आर हिंदू कारण सब ट्राइबल्स मैंने विभिन्न कैटेगोरी में नहाँ इफ यू आर नॉट क्रिश्चियन नॉट इस्लाम नॉट बुद्धिस्ट नॉट जैन नॉट सिख देन यू आर ए हिंदू तो सेठु बीजेपी कौन कला ना देखला कि नाउ इंडिया इज फॉर इंडियंस जेटा अर्णव गोस्वामी बारंबार कहला पुणी हु इज ए इंडियन मोस्टली हिंदू और हुज एनसेस्टर्स आर हिंदू दे आर द इंडियन एंड वी ऑल बिलोंग टू ए काइंड ऑफ कल्चर एंड दैट कल्चर इज नॉन एज द हिंदुस्तानी कल्चर राइट वी ऑल रिप्रेजेंट दैट कल्चर There is a coexistence of, you know, Ummah culture, Islam culture. Right. That's how BJP, through converting, all the, Aboriginal Adivasi into the caste folder and making Hindus as the majority community, and then try to attach a Hindustani culture to that majority community. And that's how it tried to develop a cultural nationalism, a nationalism whose aspiration is related with the culture, civilization, all right? That's how BJP invented the idea of cultural nationalism. Then the last question is that, how religion plays an important role in Indian politics or constitution? It's a very general question. I think what answer I will give? Better, I think, जी भी प्रश्न पचारे कि पढ़ू इट्स ए भेरी आई मीन आई विल से इट्स ए भेरी स्टैंडर्ड क्वेश्चन बट एट द सेम टाइम दिस इज ए भेरी फंडामेंटल क्वेश्चन ऑल्सो रिलीजन इन पॉलिटिक्स जनरली इन ग्रेजुएशन ये गोटे क्वेश्चन आसे आम लिखो अगेन इट इज ऑल्सो ए भेरी लॉन्ग क्वेश्चन रिलीजन इंडियन पॉलिटिक्स इंपोर्टेंट इन द रिलीजियस आइडेंटिटी And we are belonging to religion. We are thinking that first, maybe publicly, India's citizen. Then I am a Hindu. Then I am a Brahmin. But actually, practice rate is all ulta hai tha. Ulta kono? Prathame janeta nijo ghoru ko belong kare. गाँव को बिलोंग करे जाति को बिलोंग करे राज्य को बिलोंग करे पॉलिटिकल सेक्टर रे हुए सोशल सेक्टर रे हुए एथनिक सेक्टर रे भी तार बिलोंगिंगनेस गोटे छोटरु गोटे लार्जर गोटे नेरो लेवल गोटे लार्जर लेवल पर्यंत सेटा विस्तारित करी था सेठी केवल रिलीजन प्लेज एन इम्पोर्टेंट रोल नो सेठी मु कहि परिबि हाउ क्वेश्चन टा बेटर हेतन था हाउ एथनिसिटी प्लेज एन इम्पोर्टेंट रोल इन इंडियन पॉलिटिक्स जो क्वेश्चन टा फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन सहित भी टू फर्स्ट नो नो सेकंड हाँ फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन सहित जोटा भी हूँ लिंक दैट वी आर हैविंग मल्टीपल काइंड ऑफ एथनिक एथनिसिटी एंड ऑल दिस एथनिसिटी दे आर टिपिकली रिलेटेड विथ विथ द स्टेट इट इंडियन पॉलिटिक्स माने स्टेट राइट एंड कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ओके थैंक यू
ओके थैंक यू सो मच सर यू हैव टेकन ऑल द क्वेश्चन विथ With a clear answer to the students, so now this is time to thank you. I would like to thank our research faculty for your time, for your interest to speak on particularly ethnicity and nationalities. You requested to us to have a session on this particular topic. So this is really interesting topic and. I hope the students and the learners will get benefit on your critical understanding of ethnicity and nation states. You have touched upon all the aspects and all the perspectives of ethnicity and nation states. So I would like to thank you so much for the time, for your insight thought, for your critical approach to look after the topic, particular topic. So thank you so much, sir. And thank you. The technical staff to provide support to the students, to the research person, to me also, and thank you so much. Is there anything you want to say?
Thank you, Antar Jami. Thank you very much. And maybe there is another class. Maybe Vigneshwar will do that on religious politics, right?
Sure, sir. I will.
More concern day till religious politics. Now, in the religious politics also, I think that